Thank you, Willard. The movie starts Friday.
So, Howard, is this possible that we can get the money for Scott to do this?
Let me talk to Tom off the air where I can really...
That would be groundbreaking.
Be unbelievable. That would be the best day in the history of Brady.
We go to Vegas, right?
Yeah.
Send Scott up to Reno, where it's legal.
Right.
Where it's legal.
Closed circuit. It is legal.
Wait, what?
Hold on a second. Time out.
What? Time out what? Why? Gay porn is legal.
He told me it wasn't on video.
No. He's saying go to Reno,
but
where it's legal.
But... You want to film it?
No, we're going to watch you. We're going to go with you.
Oh.
We're going to report live coverage. All the grunting and the noises.
Oh. It'll be like a space launch.
Oh. Oh.
We have to get 70 miles outside of Las Vegas, and then we can do whatever we want.
Oh. Oh.
It'd be great for Gangie to interview him afterwards.
Oh. Oh.
Yeah, where are those Tourette sound effects?
Here's the broadcast. We're here with Scott the Engineer. He's about to win $250,000. Oh, ooh,
Music the way you want it. Music the way you want it. Music the way you want it. Music the way you want it.
That is music, man.
Can that money be in cash?
No.
No?
No.
Our sponsors are not going to deal in cash.
You deal with it.
Tom, you know what? I bet you there's a guy out there who wants to put up that money.
There's no
Vivid Video.
What if we paid Scott in cash and he put it on his car and drove?
Tom, what if Vivid Video gives you $1 million? Hold.
I have two words for you. Not
what?
Happening.
What?
Can I ask you a question?
That's why regular radio is going to die and satellite radio is going to win.
Okay, yeah. Let's say...
You're afraid to go into anal territory.
I have a point to make. I think I make
it.
We've given away a date with porn stars before.
We've given away dates.
A date.
Right.
Okay,
go ahead.
That's another date.
So if Scott goes off to have a date, right? Why is that any different?
Because Tom's a homophobe and against homosexuality because of his religion.
No, I'm not a homophobe at all.
Yes, you are.
I'm not.
What's the difference between one of our listeners having a date...
And Scott having
a date with a man. Tell the difference.
You have already described the parameters of this date.
Well, we gave away Who Wants to Be an Anal Millionaire between men and women.
Sure.
Butt billionaire. So that's what we're doing with Scott. Butt billionaire.
Scott's going to be the butt billionaire.
Seriously, you're anti-gay.
No, I'm not.
Come on, Tom. Don't be scared off a little ass play.
I think gays should protest you.
Yes. Go find somebody else to take you to Tiffany, okay?
You're saying gay sex is not okay.
No, I didn't say that.
Because we've done the same thing with a man and a woman.
Think about it. We've given away dates.
No, but we said...
Okay, we're giving away a date.
Happens.
We did say butt billionaire.
Yeah,
we did
do that.
No, butt billionaire. It was just because it was a nice little play on words.
Well, whatever. Right. You know what went on.
No, I don't.
I do.
Okay, well...
Howard, I say every time Scott...
You too.
If we do this, every time Scott's about to get it, we just yell, FIRE! Scott, FIRE!
No, stop. I don't want the money.
FIRE!
Where's the clock ticking?
Who let the dogs out?
Somebody call time, please.
Jesus Christ. I am shocked.
It'll be the greatest show ever.
I love that Gary the retard wanted to do it, but with a woman instead. And in case he's like, oh, no, you see, that's not the deal.
I'll tell you what, we could probably just give Gary the retard $5. I'll think it's $250,000.
I try it. Okay.
Never done it with a man.
Yeah, you could have started with $50 for him, probably.
There he goes.
Look at Tom trying not to laugh.
It's funny.
It is funny. Come on.
I don't know. It is.
Yeah.
So what are you going to do? Are you going to get some money for us or what?
No.
Why? You could sell this.
It's
going to be the biggest moment in radio history. Scott, the engineer, receiving anal for the first time.
Beautiful. Right.
This would be beautiful.
It's a shoo-in for gayest moment in the FME.
Hey, I figured if Cabby could do it for nothing, I...
You know. I tell you what, I might take this to pay-per-view.
There you go.
Yeah, there you go.
Then he'd have to be filmed.
Yeah, you have to be filmed.
But, you know, if you take...
I could get the $250 on pay-per-view.
If you take it to pay-per-view, you,
you might be able to up it a little bit to get the film right.
Hey, Howdy, we're just putting on a curtain, and we just hear the audio of it. It's well worth it.
Well, that's what I would do. I'm offering Tom an exclusive, but he's not playing with
me. You know what you do? You just have the curtain. You got to see Scott's face.
Yeah.
So his head will be poking.
Okay, yeah, we'll see his head.
You make no money, right?
Yeah, one that's of those, true.
Would you pay $50 to see this?
Of course I would in a second.
I would, too.
Right.
Do you realize?
Me too.
No problem.
People would take days off. It would be like the Super Bowl. I mean,
a party.
It'd be like a Scott getting it party.
And we got to pick. We got to pick. Are we going to get Michael J. Cox to actually do him?
I think we
could. Got to be a big guy.
What are the measurements? That
I say we get like what's his name? That disgusting
Long
guy.
Silver?
No, not Long Dunk. So I think he's dead.
Oh, like Johnny Ron Jeremy.
Ron
Jeremy.
Oh, Ron
Jeremy.
That guy. Wait. Now you're already going outside the.
Hey, we got to pick your boyfriend.
Why? Is Michael J. Cox more attractive? I don't know. I don't even know what he looks like.
Well, you care who's behind.
I'll tell you what, Scott. I'll tell you what. Tomorrow I'll bring you a Michael J. Cox movie. You can watch that.
He wants to see who his date is.
I want to know him.
Yeah.
See, Michael J.'s younger.
I don't just want to blind.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do today. I got contacts of pay for you. Tom, you're passing?
Passing.
Okay, fine. I'm announcing right now the biggest pay-per-view event in the history
ever.
Of pay-per-view.
Oh.
Bigger than WWF.
Bigger than New Kids on the Block.
That's right. Hey, I'm a businessman. I am paying Scott,
well,
the engineer.
We have to renegotiate.
No. Over. Deal over. See,
you
they all get greedy.
You said you'd do it for $250,000.
No.
You said you'd do it for $250,000. What are you worried about what I'm going to do?
No video, nothing. It was just do it. Private. It was just do it privately.
Well, I'll forget it. You know what? I can see why Tom doesn't give you a raise.
Yeah. If you're going to throw a monkey wrench into this, it's not going to happen.
Scott, $250 is enough to do on video.
But what if we do? We just have his head sticking out of the curtain.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
In the shadow.
And you can see the guy, your boyfriend's butt, you know, shaking around.
How does he train with somebody? Is he going to, like, sit on your car?
There's no training.
You go to Rikers for a month.
I don't think so.
He has a picture of Michael J. Cox, right? Here's a picture of him.
And by the way,
That's him.
I don't think Michael J. Cox is gay.
Wow.
But
we probably won't use him. I want to get Ron Jeremy.
I don't know if Ron Jeremy does that.
I think he'll do it.
He'll do it for $250.
He'll do it to get on the show.
I think Tom should give it to Scott.
Also not happening.
He has been.
Scott says Tom's been doing it.
How much for Tom to pleasure himself when it's happening?
Oh.
What is it, Dominic?
All right, first of all, the station has to allow it. Number one, it's a violation of equal rights. You've done it with male and a woman. And secondly,
Dominic, why don't you mind your own business, Dominic?
And the station could actually be fined.
Have a cannoli for breakfast, okay?
Prejudice, thank you.
I think the station could be fined for prejudice.
I think you should be fined for overeating.
Yeah, for consuming too much on the planet.
Exactly.
I pay $50. You would, Dominic, you wouldn't pay $50 on pay-per-view to see Scott the Engineer do this?
I'll pay the $250,000.
Brought to you by Dominic Barber. Well, I tell you what I'm going to do for you, my friend.
Yeah.
Here's the whole setup.
He said he wants to renegotiate.
Hold it. I got the deal. And this is it. Take it or leave it deal.
What does everybody give me a take it or leave it?
I'll tell you why. Because you're a schnurrer. Yeah. $250,000 I'm offering you as a talent fee. There's a curtain. We have to see your head and your chest at least. And we get a guy of our choosing. We'll have him tested.
And he's wearing a condom.
He's wearing a condom.
Son, watch that on TV.
Oh, man. And you will receive, and people will tune in to see it. That's it. 2 minutes. Ultimate fighting, nothing.
Hey, Scott. It's a 3-minute show.
It's a 3-minute show. If you want to, if you want to
take a view in history,
if you want to see it. I can drag it up for a half hour if that's what you need.
Yeah, and you can have some build up.
Yeah, I'll have little cut-in pieces.
We need to have a band play.
Yeah. No.
No, interview the guy, interview people.
It's like the tail of the tape. You would meet the two components of
right.
this event.
You have to have an undercard.
We'll have ACDC. For those about to take anal, Scott the Engineer is going to get anal. A little dirty deeds done dirt cheap. Yeah.
Fire!
Fire!
Michael J. Cox, fire!
What is that thing you said the guys talk about, the 21 gun salute?
Yeah. Pick up your balls for a 21 gun salute. Yeah.
Hey, does he realize how long 2 minutes is going to be?
Oh, my God. It's going to be like 5 hours.
You realize it's going to be intense.
2 minutes.
Yeah, we got to have a big clock.
I think he wants it.
I do. I'll take it now.
All right, so you're up for this?
Sure.
The way I do. Okay. You don't want to be involved? I'm going to talk to Mel about it today. He probably want to be involved.
Okay, yeah. Sure.
Come on.
I'm serious.
Great event.
You know how much money this is going to generate?
Oh, forget it. This is better than a fight.
And cheaper to produce.
Tom, just picture.
And we don't have any commissions
shut up,
to worry
you.
About.
What? Just picture his face.
First of all, this is like softcore porn. You're not going to see actual, you know,
right.
sex.
This is Showtime at Saturday at 1 in the morning.
That's right. This is Cinemax After Dark.
Exactly.
Tom, come on. Have a heart.
There is nobody that's going to see that.
You don't Casey. Let us do the negotiation.
Tom doesn't mind it from me. He minds it from you.
It's not a bad title, though.
Yeah, all right, Tom. Thank you.
Probably it's a title we'll make it on the air.
I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to do it here in the studio because you won't get a sponsor for us.
Right.
I think you're prejudiced against gay people.
I'm not.
Yes.
I do. I think that's not fair.
You're entitled to your opinion.
What is your objection?
I already stated my objection.
He's against gay sex.
No.
Smooth, go ahead, you're on the air.
Hey, Al, listen. Bump it up to half a million and make sure it's a black guy.
Black guy?
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. That matters to
black guy. Scott, do you have sex with blacks?
Huh?
Well, I never have.
All right, well, here's your first.
Half a million, bro.
A lot of firsts going on.
Does Scott choose a guy or do we choose a guy?
We choose a guy.
Choose yeah, so we can choose anybody.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we're gonna have a whole audition.
You
know what? That's the first hour of the pay-per-view.
Yeah. Wait a minute. Wait.
Auditioning the men.
I got two.
But we gotta make sure.
Like American Idol.
How do we make sure he'll be able to?
That's right. He's gotta be
able to perform.
Tested. I got two.
I mean, this is tested. Arena live. You know, you don't want to leave this to chance.
Howard, I got two words for you, Mark Harris.
He loves the camera.
At the very least, he can sing the national anthem.
Nah,
right.
He'd be too nice. We need someone rough.
You got to get a gay guy to sing the national anthem.
If you could that's Mark's.
Do you think your wife's going to let this happen?
I was thinking the same thing.
No. Oh, look at Scott. Like, I don't have to ask my wife. Forget it. Here's the opening of the actual event. We got the whole thing worked out.
Every country around the world has their own national song,
I can't do this.
Which is their symbol of what their nation stands for. Our Star-Spangled Banner, which is the title we use for our national anthem,
yes.
is just like saying Old Glory. That means the flag of the United States of America. It's my patriotic privilege for me to sing our national anthem.
Fire! Fire!
By the dawn's early light.
Yeah, Vinny.
Hey, Howard, with one phone call, I think I can get us in 10 million homes on DirecTV.
Why not?
I mean, I can do it. Just give me the green light. I'll call today.
You're green lit.
All right.
All right, Vinny.
Blue Bop, get ready.
Get ready.
Can I just,
Vinny, you understand commercial potential. I think this is huge.
Oh, my God. You would make so much money. We could make this thing like at like $4.99, and you could make about $20 million.
That's right. Everyone would tune in to see Scott.
Vinny at the Indianapolis 500.
A lot of money.
You know what, Howard? You know how big this is? I would pay $50 just to be allowed to think about it.
Hey,
that's
Vinny,
how funny it is.
Vinny, where are you with all those cars?
I'm on my way to Brooklyn. I have to go to a funeral.
Oh.
Who died? Yeah. Scott's parents, because they heard this?
Hey, we can call it like, it's like a Super Bowl, you know? Like a Super Bowl party. And a tailgate party. We're going to have tailgates for Scott's tail.
Thank you, Vinny.
Okay, bye.
All right, Vinny, working overtime with ideas.
He's got the ideas going.
Jesus Christ. Your wife's going to let you do this? Seriously.
Let's call her.
Yes.
You look insulted when I ask you.
No. She doesn't care. Not insulted. Why would she care?
Because you close your eyes. Like,
why would she care? Why would she care?
Why would she care? You're her husband. You're going to be the laughing stock of the world.
Yes.
He already is.
What's the difference? There's a difference.
There's a difference.
You are tackling your
ground. By the way, you think you're going to be able to have sex with a woman after
gay
this?
You guys do it every day for nothing.
Yeah, but so they're what? Gay.
Hey, Howard, can you imagine if Scott gets aroused?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, too. That'd be funny.
No, it ain't happening.
If he does get into it, that'd be great.
That ain't happening.
What if it's easy for him?
What if this is how you find out you're gay?
Hey, what if it's a quarter million to start your new life?
There you go.
Yes, Scott, you're on the air.
Hey, Howard, how you doing?
All right.
I have 9 inches of hot, steaming conga. And I would like to audition as the giver.
Well, hold on, and we'll take your name down because we're going to do a whole auditioning process.
It's got to be over a foot, though.
Leading up to it. Thank you. Let me get the hell out of here. That's what we're going to be looking for.
No.
This guy,
see,
hold on.
He's changing everything.
What do you mean I'm changing everything?
We never said who would be.
Ron Jeremy.
I'll make a deal with you. It has to measure exactly what Michael J. Cox measures.
No. No deal, nothing.
You see, he's a star.
You see, you're changing everything. Now it's on television.
So what? You're
changing all the parameters.
Well, you said so far, you said right here.
You said you'd do it right here in the studio. The camera's here.
Yeah, and you also said it didn't matter what guy it was.
Plus, I'm going to put a blanket over you like a horse, so no one's going to really see anything.
So I take my pants off, okay? Just like cut.
You do whatever you want.
whatever works for you.
We're going to need judges back there to make sure everything's going on, and I'll take a look and see that I got to do the play-by-play.
Judges.
You know, I'm going to get one of these play-by-play guys.
Yeah, get like Madden or something.
Yes.
Yeah, Madden's are there looking wonderful.
Madden.
Sit
there and do the X's and the O's.
And it counts.
Yeah. I can't wait.
That's groundbreaking.
I'm doing it.
I'm
Tom,
shaking.
I'm moving ahead without you. I'm sorry. Usually we're in business together, but I can see you're bowing out.
I am.
Making a mistake.
Yes.
Jingleberries.
Scott the engineer, yes.
Wow. Boy, you shocked me with this.
Wow.
Astonishing.
We should call your wife and see if she'll let you.
You know it'll be shut down tomorrow when he comes in.
I spoke to my wife, and she doesn't want me doing it because we have a son.
Who wants to take her alibi with me right now that tomorrow morning is
I say he can't. He's not allowed to do it.
I agree with you. Absolutely.
I spoke to my wife.
What about a son?
Probably found something Leno won't steal. I don't think anyone's stealing this.
Yes, I understand. You get a thing, and I take some
ale. Well, tonight we have something really unusual. We have one of our engineers going to have anal.
Yeah.
From a man.
Hey, Kevin, listen to this. I understand one of our engineers.
So it's a little more embarrassing than walking down the street in a Brahm panty.
I think so.
Yeah. A little more. Just a little more.
But honestly, your son is like, hey, I heard your father's on TV. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Great day in school.
Yeah, we're having a party.
You going to tell your son you're doing this?
Yeah.
Son, you know we've always been open with one another.
Let me teach you how to provide.
Which one's your father? He's the guy sticking his head out of the car.
Oh, he's the receiver?
Yeah,
I didn't realize he was the woman. You should be ashamed.
That would be
I thought he was the man.
That would be doing like the dating game. Our first potential giver is a stock analyst.
Son, I didn't mean that kind of catcher.
You're really going to go ahead with this? Because I'm working on it. And you're not going to ask your wife permission?
No.
Right. Yeah, right.
Yeah.
It's amazing. It's like he's calm about it.
He's like,
well, now he is, but when the wife gets a hold of him.
Scott!
No problem.
No way. No effing way.
It's like the Honeymooners. Alice, I don't care what you say. I'm taking anal.
Another one of your kooky ideas.
Yeah.
But the point is, she would benefit from this as well. I mean, it would be her money as well.
I know what Scott's. I mean, I talk to Scott all the time. Scott will like do a little addition, clean up the house, get a couple of new cars, put some money away for his kids' college.
Five-year salary.
Yep.
5 years.
Every time you sit in that addition, though, it's gonna hurt.
2 minutes.
2 minutes.
5 years.
2 minutes.
In 2 minutes.
Wow. That's right. You make 5 years' salary in 2 minutes.
So you think
and 30 years of embarrassment.
If you were 60, you could retire
after a lifetime.
You're doing this for a den.
Are you shocked, Tom?
I'm very surprised.
You represent middle America to me. I mean, you represent the middleest of America.
The middleest?
The milquetoast America. Are you shocked by this?
Yes.
You are. That's what I thought.
I'm with him, I got to say. I would never buy that in a second.
Would you want to watch
it? I still not buy. No.
You won't watch?
No. Some things I don't want to see.
But isn't that fun?
I want to see it.
It's why? I just don't.
Just I want to see it.
Okay.
Well, I would be on
does it make me
tackle.
A bad person?
Just what's the gross on something like this? Give me a guess.
Apparently, Vinny's the expert, so get Vinny back.
Plenty gross.
100,000 homes, 50 bucks a pop. What's that, 5 million?
Yes. No. 100,000 homes of 50 bucks a pop, you have $5 million.
$5 million.
And I think you could do more than 100,000 homes.
Yeah. Oh,
more than
too.
$50 bucks.
A million homes, easy.
A million homes. Mm.
Are you kidding?
$50 million. I think every home in America will.
You're on it, Howard.
I think there'll be parties.
There'll be people getting cable.
Howard, how many listeners do you have?
Right. Just to see this.
How many listeners do you have across the country?
About 20 million.
About 20 million. You don't think at least, you know, 10% of that?
I don't know who would tune in to see Scott receive anal.
Scott, if I were you, I'd hold out for some back end.
Would it be a replay or is just a one-shot
one-shot event.
I want
you're
going to
want points.
Points, back end.
Yes, Leroy.
Yeah, I'll come down and I'll give some Scott some dirty black beef kebab, baby. I'll do it for $20.
Well, there's a black guy who wants to come down and give it to Scott. Kay Ramon, what's up?
Oh, no.
Just Kay.
Hey, Howard, what's up, baby? You know I'll do this.
Of course we know you'll do this.
You know what, Ramon? I don't even know that you're large enough. We have to find the right man.
Nope.
You can certainly audition.
I think he wants to do it.
Look at him.
Yeah, I'm starting to wonder.
I think he wants to do it probably because he gets a smoke out to it, you big gay bastard. Look at you.
Oh, look who's talking.
You're gay. That's so gay. I would never do that.
I wonder what Scott DePace is thinking.
He told me gay.
He's all freaked out about gay stuff. Hey, Scott, come in here and tell me what you think.
I'm going to go. Work with Scott.
Let's get I might hire Scott as the director on this.
It's up to you.
Scott DePace, I mean.
That ran on the top of your resume.
DePace, what do you think?
I'm not directing this.
Wait a minute. You want to be the giver?
Oh, my God.
Scott.
Dude, you are crazy. What's wrong with you?
I'm crazy. I've lost my mind.
$250 after taxes. Well, you know what? I don't want to talk him out of it, but... DePace, you grabbed nuts for a video game.
Yeah, he went gay.
Yeah,
he's
an Xbox.
He went gay.
Wow.
Scott DePace, you do have a price, though, right?
Scott, have you ever had...
I think I do have a price.
What's your price?
We talked about it in there. It's lower than what you guys are saying, but probably...
Half a million.
No cameras, maybe $3 to $4 million.
Oh. See, he does have a price.
God, wow. Everybody has should a price. Not have a price.
No, he thought about it. You can tell he's thought a lot of thought went into it. You gave off a lot
of things for about $3 million.
See, this is a great game show. How gay would you go for what amount of money?
I'd turn fag for $4 million.
So, and $1 billion, you wouldn't?
$1 billion? I don't care if it's $10 billion.
Dude, a billion.
I wouldn't be able to sleep.
Yeah. He's got a price. You could have that.
You could buy your own country. And stock it with people who don't know who you are.
You can never go back. You can never go back. Ever.
Casey, you wouldn't do it for $1 billion.
No.
Oh,
no.
Oh, Casey. See, I think Scott the engineer has been waiting for a chance. Wow.
What must that feel? I mean, it.
Oh, you want to do it?
No, I'm just saying.
You want to know?
Scott will describe it to you if he has it.
Oh.
Dead double A.
Hey, Howard, it sounds like you're putting together the best Vegas show ever. I cannot wait for this event to take place.
Well, I don't know that this will take place in Vegas.
We're going to have to go to Honduras.
Most states won't allow it. But we're going to work it out, and I'm going to start working on this great pay-per-view event. It'll be the greatest pay-per-view event in the history of pay-per-view.
Let me tell you something. The answer should always be, if you're 100% man, no money in the world should turn you into a homo. Scott, you are one big homo.
Right.
Thank you.
I've just been contacted by my people in the Howard Stern Production Company. We're probably going to be shooting from the Philippines. All right, thank you.
Take care.
Yes, double A. All right, look, we're going to take a break. Scott the engineer, I hear what you're saying, and let me see if I can make your dream come true.
Yes.
And you check with your wife. I still say she's going
to
say no.
Nothing to check.
Can we call her on the air?
Wait, you want it.
Huh? Call your wife on the air, and I guarantee you she says no. Yeah, Ralph, what's up?
Unbelievable.
This is unbelievable.
Scott, $250,000, that's it?
That's it.
John got $100,000 for boxing.
That's true.
This is all I'm offering.
Yeah, but it's just 2 minutes.
And believe me, where's he ever going to make that kind of money?
That's well, right. Yeah, hey, it's a lot of money for him, but what you got to do, it's not.
Well, Ralph, you do it for free.
Oh.
I'll pitch it to him for another $250.
Oh.
Are you going to watch the pay-per-view?
Oh. Please, yes.
He's going to do Scott's hair.
Yeah, I can picture a camera just right tight on his face and this expression all the time.
Sweat poured off his forehead.
All right, there you go. Everybody excited about pay-per-view. All right, we got to take a break, Rob. When we come back, we are going to do the news. Pay-per-view.
Coming to you live from an opium den in Southeast Asia.
We'll be back right after these words.
Howard Stern Show.
I told you not to use the goddamn tank. Get out of my way! Now stay out of my face! Get out of my face!
Surprise, she's a bull with a shock.
I'm still
Scott from the block. I got as much hair as a rock.
Scott.
I bought a new house, I got no place to smoke. I'm as exciting as a sock. I'm still Scott from the block.
Scott.
I smoke and smoke and smoke around the clock. Before Christmas comes, I'm probably gonna croak. Every day is dull, nothing is rolling. My weekend consists of smoking and bowling. I pound my head against the wall. I'm a loser's loser, I'm balder than bald. I scream at all the interns.
Get out of here.
I'm a son of a bee. I have no answers, I probably have cancer. When I talk, I put people to sleep. My whole existence is a crock.
I'm still
Scott from the block. I should buy a cemetery plot. I can hardly breathe because my lungs are shot. I'm never gonna be a big shot.
I'm still
Scott from the block. Every year my birthday gets forgot by Howard and Robin and everybody else. I haven't got piss, nothing to my name. When I leave a party, no one knows I came. I have the kind of face everyone forgets. The only friend I have is a pack of cigarettes. I've got a crappy house, I've got a crappy car, and the worst luck that you've seen. My poor wife, she wonders why she married a skinhead schmuck like me. I've got all the charm of a box. I'm still Scott from the block. I've got as much hair as a rock. The tar in my lungs could fill up a crock pot. I'm as exciting as a sock.
I'm still
Scott from the block. I smoke and smoke and smoke around the clock. Before Christmas comes, I'll probably die of cancer.
You hit me with the worst! If it wasn't a push-up, you would have blown it more! That's all I got to say!
Oh, all that rage will be effed away.
Oh, man.
It might be good for him.
Yeah.
Tim, what's up?
What's up?
Hey.
Hello there.
Hey there.
Hey, I want to know what happens if the pitcher leaks out before the 2 minutes is up.
That's a good point.
Is that an extra $250,000?
Man, that's we gotta have a backup dude. We might be multiple guys.
There you go.
We need a full 2 minutes there. Wombat, go ahead.
Hey, Howard, what's up? How you doing? Hey, how about Anal by America? You line up 20 contestants and have the viewers decide who gives Scott anal.
America votes. You know, we could do that because it'll be live pay-per-view, so.
That's true. We can get the tally right there.
We can interview our 20 guys and then have America vote. That's good. I like it. Okay. We'll right, work on that, Wombat.
Hey, Artie, you rock. Great ACD impression.
Thank you.
Yeah.
All right. See you guys later.
I'm just going to call you Brian Johnson from now on and just answer everything as Brian.
Yeah. Whatever you need.
But this is about to rock.
Yeah.
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 Every time I just call him Brian Johnson, you should just say, fire!
Fire! Fire! Fire! Fire! You're having some dirty deeds done yet, cheap down. Yeah, fire!
Scott, you want to call your wife, and then I got to talk to Dougie, the limbless rapper. I want to talk to that guy.
Yeah.
He's got no arms and no legs, and he raps. He's pretty good, actually. I heard some tape of him. He's not bad. He just,
yeah?
I just can't figure out. He says he pleasures himself, but I don't see how he can do it. He draws, puts the pen between his cheek and his neck.
Unbelievable.
You're kidding.
You know how to die in your house? All right. I'll take care of that. Your wife home?
I hope so.
I hope so.
Believe me, it's easier if I ask her than if you do.
I keep her in the style of a kept woman. I think you're going to have to,
What?
We're sorry. We cannot complete your call.
You did it wrong.
Time.
I think you got to dial, like, our phones are so sucky. Scott's an engineer. We can't even do it. Hmm. What's it? You dial 9, maybe? No, you don't have to dial 9.
Yes, you do.
Oh, you do? Keeping the dialing down so no one will find out that Scott the engineer phone number. So hope your son's not home.
Yeah, really.
The number you are calling has call intercept.
Wait.
A service that requires callers whose telephone numbers do not appear.
Oh, you need star 82.
I got it.
Hold
on.
All right.
50 attempts later.
What do I do now?
It'll ring.
No, there's no, I took it, I hung up. Do it again. Sorry.
Once again.
Come back here.
Tell me when to pot up. Wow. I'd never be able to make this call. It's ringing now, dude. Hope she's home.
The number you are calling has call inter...
I'll bring it up.
Okay,
thank you.
Thank
connecting
you.
Now.
Thank you.
Connecting.
I'm going to intercept.
It's got to be connecting. After all that, your wife's not going to be
she's
home.
She's not home.
Well, maybe she might be going.
She's already driving.
She's
away.
Running.
She already left the country. She's driving cross country now.
She's outscoring Angel Dust.
No, she's not home.
Hi, we're not available right now, so please leave us a message. We'll get back to you as soon as we can. Thanks for calling. Bye.
Yeah. I have a message.
Fire! Robin, are you there? It's Howard Stern.
She can't hear
it. Oh, it's a voicemail?
Yeah.
Here's my message. You should ask Scott what he's going to be doing.
What he's going to be up to bring in some extra cash.
Scott figured out a way to make $250,000 in 2 minutes.
I got a part-time job.
Yeah. So I just wanted to know if you approve or not.
Just giving you the heads up to ask, well, how was work today?
All right.
We're calling to let you know Scott's going to be up to some dirty deeds.
Do you have a cell phone on her?
No.
Really?
I can't afford it.
Well, you will be able to soon. Well, Scott's bursting his ass to make some extra money. Not busting, bursting.
Anything for the family.
Right.
I got college coming up in next year, so.
Scott the engine queer.
Let's call your son at school.
Yeah.
All right. Robin, I'll talk to you later. Bye. If you get a hold of her, look, we'll come running in here, okay? I think it'll be easier for you to tell your wife this on the air.
I'll come right in.
All right. Because he's acting like, I don't have to ask my wife. The beaten
no,
man.
If he wants to do it, he doesn't.
Won't that be fun on the special? Like you tune in and then America decides who gives Scott anal?
I like that.
Me too.
And I like the idea of him walking out to Scott from the block in like a bathrobe getting ready for it.
What's he going to wear? Hey, here's Dougie. I'm going to give him a plug. You guys had a tough life.
I saw his concert movie that he put out not too long ago. And I know that one of the things he was doing was like it was a hot pregnant woman contest.
Yeah. That's not stand-up comedy.
No. And then I know he went somewhere and he ate some buffalo testicles for his movie.
Well, we're going to do pay-per-view with Scott getting anal.
That's a home run, dude.
Everyone can't wait for it. Meanwhile, Ronnie, the limo driver, said there is no way on this planet Scott's wife is letting him do it.
Of course not.
Scott's walking around like he's going to do it.
I'm the king of
but
my
he
castle.
Walks around like that a lot and winds up not being able to do stuff.
How many times has he walked around here with his head held high, only to come in the next morning all hunched over? You know.
But why does he listen to his wife so much? What happened to him? Why is he so pussy-whipped?
He's always been that way.
I know, but I mean, my God.
But now he's in a bad spot because he just bought a new house. He can't go
anywhere. But what do you mean?
He can't go anywhere. Where's he going to go?
I'm not saying go anywhere, but he just say, listen, this is something I wanted. This is something I need to do. And it's none of your business.
It's kind of hard to argue a lot for anal.
I mean, I'm a human being separate from you, and I want to go do anal from a man for $250,000. I'm my own gay person. Although it is cheating.
Lisa's
that's the other thing.
Breaking
we gotta...
his vow.
Oh, my God. Is that for free?
Hey,
he's
it's sex.
He's got honey.
Kind of funny. Well, he did have to finish, darling.
It would be rude.
The guy we select to give it to Scott on the pay-per-view special,
yeah.
We got to make sure he can, like, finish in 2 minutes.
Right. So they got to be ready to go.
I said 2 minutes and not a second.
Get the clock. Like, at a minute 30, he should begin winding up.
No, a minute 45. You wanna...
Harder. 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 You might have a heart attack right during the pay-per-view special.
I'm
Jeez. Any chance he could lose control during it, Scott?
Oh, I think maybe he should prepare, don't you?
Animus?
Yeah.
I think there's an excellent chance he could lose control.
Well, wait a second. Hold it. Stop the clock. Stop the clock.
I'm having an episode.
When we think he would get himself ready.
Wait a minute. Ronnie says no way.
If I have to do an enema, it's all out. No enemas.
Well, it's up
Oh, you don't have to. I hope you
but
don't you take an enema.
You might like to, so you'd avoid an accident.
No, I don't care.
I don't want you to take an enema.
Scott, you'll be getting a skin enema.
Ronnie says no way your wife's letting you do this. Are you going to put your foot down and say, this is something I got to do?
What? Hey, whatever I got to do to support my family...
You're going to do it.
I'm doing it.
I forget. What was the last thing he said he was going to be able to do? And then it was, going to driving school.
Yeah.
I went.
Yeah, right.
That's not supporting my family.
All right.
Well, it is technically cheating, but.
Well, not really.
No. Not really. It's a man.
I mean, you don't plan to see this guy again.
And you never know.
Is this something you've wanted to try?
Never thought about it.
Right.
But do you think you'll enjoy it in some way?
I don't think so.
I don't know. Could be. At least it's intimacy. And sharing one's expression of love with another one.
Did you get a hold of your wife yet?
No.
Want to try again?
I just did back there. And oh. She's not home yet. She's already out spending the money, so don't worry about it.
Well, have her call in tomorrow.
Okay. To give permission.
Oh, wait a second. I'm uncomfortable. Can you stop the clock for a second? Oh. All right, let's continue.
Ready.
Dude, this is going to be the greatest. The pay-per-view special is going to be the greatest special ever.
Can you overtax pay-per-view? There's no shutting it down.
We might shut it down. It'd be like Woodstock. The New York State Thruway will be closed. We should have live audience, too.
Wait a minute. You're changing everything now.
No, but
you're changing everything.
It's not changing anything. You're not going to be able to see it. You'll be behind the sheet.
Your head's going to be sticking out of the sheet. From what I agreed to with Casey when he asked me.
Here you go. What difference does it make?
Dude, how am I going to get... I got to get you the $250,000.
Of course it makes a difference.
The only way to get the $250,000 if I raise money.
Well, no. See if you can get it the first wave.
Here he goes. What first wave?
Go to Tom and get a sponsor?
Well, if you're doing a pay-per-view, then it should be a lot more money.
Goodbye. Over. Offer off the table.
Fine.
That's it. Done.
You know what? Fine.
Good. Okay.
You know,
no $250.
I mean, this is...
You're funny.
This is not going to
tickle. See, like all of a sudden...
He's got dreams.
Of course. You count what I'm going to make.
What if nobody subscribes?
You going to pay me? You going to give me $250,000?
Your work is going to be the biggest pay-per-view.
And you're going to pay me all the different fees that I'm going to have to pay up front?
No, you want to do the pay-per-view.
You're going
to
pay?
You're the one that wanted to do the pay-per-view.
I offered you $250,000. What's the difference how I get it to you?
Always comes
back. Always, Scott. Always a fight. Get out. I'm done. Goodbye. Bit over.
Scott, you beat an ass.
Yes. Yes, Scott, don't be an ass.
You're like so many guys I know. All of a sudden, they're like...
Don't be an ass. No, yo.
There's no one in your lifetime is ever going to offer you $250,000 to do anything. And now suddenly, you're like...
Yeah, and the point was, this is what he would do for $250,000. Now, what you would do for $1 million is something else.
Yeah.
You have to make out with him.
I'm going to raise $250,000 to see this. And it's exactly what I said it was going
to
be.
That wasn't what I said yes to. I'm just telling you that wasn't what I said.
Do you want
to
do it or not? Yes or no?
It's pay-per-view.
Yes or no?
Scott, do it. Were you crazy?
Well, you want to see it.
Oh, I can't.
Everyone wants to see it.
I'm laughing my head off.
But you want the $250,000.
I mean, what am I going to do? I'm not going to pay you $250,000 of my money.
If you made an agreement with somebody, then they changed it, you would say...
I'm not changing anything.
Of course you do.
You said you would have...
Anal
for
$250,000.
That's all that's happening.
No video.
I'm not going to videotape the actual anal. Just your face.
You said you do it right here.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, there's cameras everywhere.
This isn't pay-per-view, is it?
So now you know the deal.
Don't act like a girl.
Yes or no?
Oh, please. Look,
so now you know the deal.
Like,
do you want the deal or not? That's it. I'm not going to sit there and bust my balls.
How else are we going to get the money? Tom won't have any part of this.
What do you think, Scott, the engineer, is going to command $250 anywhere on this planet for the rest of his life? No way. You need me more than I need you.
Scott.
If I don't do this, I don't care. I
Scott, don't act like a girl. Let a guy bang you.
I love Scott all of a sudden. Yeah.
Not
what is
all
it, Roddy?
Of a sudden.
You want $250. This is how we're going to get it. Money's got to be raised. What is it, Ronnie?
Ralph?
Dude, you're wasting your time here.
Why?
Because you know what happened.
His wife.
He got the phone call.
Oh, that's what happened.
Come on, man. You know she's not going to let you do this.
I'm so
what
stupid. Of
doing?
Course you're right.
I
of course you're right. He got the phone call already.
No, I didn't.
Come on. You know she's not going to let him do this. He couldn't even go to NASCAR school. She's going to let him do this.
I didn't get a phone call.
But this is money.
I don't care.
It's our money, too.
Yeah, Roddy, I think you're wrong. I think just because of the money amount, you know, they'll be all close to...
Dude, his kid's got to go to school the next day after that. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, that's what I want to say. Scott, have you no shame for your children? And how old's your son?
He's 17.
17. You realize how hard life is at 17 when you're a kid and you're going to keep this on him?
Hey, what are you guys bumming him out
for?
Yeah,
stop. Really, we're trying to get this done. You...
Look how his face changed from the time he was sitting in here before
till
now.
I think he wants it.
Look at him now.
He wants the $250.
Something happened between now and then.
His wife got a hold of him. You're right.
No.
You're not allowed to tell when your wife gets a hold of you.
I said it before when I was in here that you're changing the parameters.
No, the parameters always were what you would do for $250,000.
You said you'd do anal. I said I could get $250,000 from Tom. I couldn't. I went to the next step. I said, I'll put it on pay-per-view. We'll put a sheet up. We'll look at your head while you get it.
But the price was always what he'd do for $250,000.
Right. Now all of a sudden you're like,
Scott, the other one is supposed to be getting screwed. That happened.
Change the parameters. I'm not, listen, dude, I'm just trying to get you the money.
Oh, you're a good guy for that.
I mean, no one else is going to do anything for you.
One way or another.
Tom won't even give you a raise for what you actually do.
I'm trying to build excitement here for the event.
Oh, it's exciting.
Build excitement.
So is he backing out? Is Ralph
getting turned on by it?
Oh, yeah.
Listen, don't waste my time. Are you into this or not? I don't understand what you're saying.
Yeah, the money could be better. If it's going on pay-per-view. That's all I'm saying.
He's
smelling money.
You didn't say
that's
it would
right.
take more money to get you to do
$250.
That.
I'll get the money.
Scott,
you do
the
it.
The point is,
don't
Scott,
count what's
Howard,
in my wallet.
Without Howard, you're not getting anything.
Hey, Scott, it's like when the fight with the
Hunter. Excuse me. I don't have to beg this guy.
No. The point
there's
was,
no one on the planet that would offer him this.
Would he do this for $250,000? What else are you doing? That's all you're doing.
Hey, Scott, go find someone else to pay you the money. That's all.
Okay.
That's all.
That's so, I can't believe how weird you are.
Because something happened. The wife got a hold of him.
Yeah, somebody.
You were gung-ho about it.
Yeah, there's a lot of other people in
somebody
the market.
Somebody grabbed him and said, Howard's going to make $800 million off this, and you should make
Right.
But, Scott, you still get the $250,000 no matter what happens.
And no
it's
one's going
to
give it
to you.
Now, he's thinking what he isn't getting. Remember how Viacom's getting 12%?
You know what he isn't getting?
You know how Viacom makes $560 million? You still got no raise.
Right. And Scott, he's getting the same thing. He's getting nothing.
Don't listen to other people. You see how well it worked out for Jack?
Yeah, that's what he's selling, Jack.
If it wasn't for me, no one would have any interest in you getting rammed. You'd be doing it on back alley.
He'd be doing it for free or paying like he probably already
is. You want $250, I'll get you $250.
That's what you said that it would take to get you to do it.
I'm not willing to get you $1 million. I'm not willing to get you $251,000. I'll give you the $250,000.
He's taking a gamble.
Do you understand that?
You're not gambling. He's gambling.
I'm not gambling.
No, you're...
No.
You get $250,000
no matter what. If seven people tune in, you still get $250,000.
What is that off the back end?
I don't care if he does it or not. Just give me an answer so I don't waste my time.
But he's the one who's welching. The question was, the guy wants to give $250,000. Will you do it? Yes was
quarter of $1 million. Vinny Favalli.
Howard, I need to explain the economics to Scott there. Scott, it's a huge gamble. It's not like there's money just waiting to be had.
That's in Scott's world.
Get the money for the production to do the actual event. That's not going to be for free. We have to get $250,000 to give you before we've raised any money.
Right.
And then all of a sudden we're partners like 50-50 with the pay-per-view people who want their money first.
Yeah, Vinny, please. I'm not going to convince the dude. If you can get a better deal somewhere, get it.
Scott, you're insane. Just bend over and do it.
If you're going to do it, it shouldn't matter about anything else, Scott.
It's, I don't, you know, end of discussion. I thought the guy wanted $250,000 to have some anal.
That's what the game is.
You don't want it? Turn it down.
What was the question? What was the original question?
The original question is, would you have anal with a man for $250,000? You said yes.
In private.
That's right.
No, the guy was putting it in a book. You were always going to be publicized. But
Scott, how's it worth anything to us if it's private?
Hey, wait a second. All this is moot anyway. Because you got to ask your wife. Robin.
Hello.
Hi. Robin?
Yeah?
Howard Stern.
Hi, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good. Got your message.
Okay, good. Robin, here's the deal.
Go ahead.
We did this thing with Scott.
Yeah.
We asked him, all right, Scott, if someone paid you $250,000.
Right, a lot of money.
Would you have anal sex with a man for 2 minutes?
Right.
He's going to write a book about it. The guy's name is
Michael J. Cox.
Right.
So anyway, Scott said he would do it for the $250,000. He'd be willing to do it.
Right.
So I said, if you're willing to do it, let me see if Tom will sponsor it.
Absolutely not. Tom wouldn't do that.
Right. So Tom wouldn't sponsor it. So I said to Scott, I'll tell you what I'll do. If you want $250,000, I'll put you behind a sheet, stick your head out the sheet so we can see your face, and we'll do a special where we'll pick a guy. Probably a very large man to give you anal on TV for 2 minutes, and I'll pay you $250,000. And he said, I'm doing it. I'm in.
Okay.
Now, I said there's no way you'd let him.
He could do it.
You don't care.
I don't care. $250,000 is right in my pocket.
That's right. It goes right in your pocket.
That's right.
Do I get any of it?
No, you just get the pleasure.
Right. I tell you what, Robin.
I'll tell you this. When he has to go for a hemorrhoid after me, I'm not going to be there.
Well, you don't have to be. But it is something that he would do this for $250,000.
He loves his family.
Be my guest. I would love to refurnish my whole home.
By the way, if you want to be one of the judges to pick the man, we could probably work you in.
That's fine with me.
Okay, that's all I needed to hear. Thank you, Robin.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
She'll divorce him as soon as the check's cashed.
Who cares? She's in.
Wow.
So, Scott, are you in? That's the question.
Well, and then I got to call pay-per-view to see if I can even get this on the air.
Hey, who knows?
There's still something, but I don't waste my time. If you're up for it, I'll do it.
All right. Let's do it.
Okay.
Okay.
Dominic Barber, go ahead.
Yeah, Scott, do you remember when you almost blew the money, the push-up money, and we saved it and gave it to you?
Yes.
Don't do that again. You're going to do it. What's the difference where and how? Everyone's going
to... He's in, Dominic.
He just said yes. We're done.
The wife said yes. She signed off. I will now contact pay-per-view, see if this kind of event can be held, and let me get to it.
Wow.
Let's let the games begin. Thank you.
God.
This is really astonishing.
This is amazing. I will get back to you by... What's today? Wednesday?
Yes.
By Friday, I'll tell you whether or not we can do this.
Okay.
I'll make some calls. I'll have my agent make some calls.
Oh, this poor agent.
I don't even want to make the call. I don't even know how to make the call to my agent.
Right. I mean, can you imagine having to pick up a phone and now try to describe this to somebody?
You know, Don, I go, Don, okay, I have an idea. So we're on the air, and Scott the engineer says, you would take anal for $250,000. Yeah.
I got a guy on the phone that says by tomorrow he can come over here and put up $300,000 to do it.
Why?
Line three. Because he's got a bunch of internet companies. He's got the money.
Roland.
Yes, sir.
Hey, what are you talking about?
Hey, Howard, how you doing, man?
Talk business now.
Let's do it. I mean, you put it together. You and I will talk business, but I'll put up, as a matter of fact, I'll put up $300,000 so he shuts up.
So, but then you want what? Cut of the pay-per-view?
We'll talk very small numbers for me. Recoup some of the $300,000.
Why are you putting up the $300,000? What do you want out of it?
You know what? I want to sit in front of my TV. I say like a front row seat. I don't think he'll do it. I think he'll back out. But I'll put up the $300,000.
Well, there you go.
To do it. I mean, we'll work out the numbers.
Well, let me put you on hold, and I'll have my agent get in touch with you.
Absolutely.
All right, hold on.
We'll be there, and we'll get this thing done. Because,
all right. Thank you, Roland.
I think it'll be the biggest thing ever.
Oh,
thank you, Roland.
I think we finally topped the Japanese.
Who wouldn't want
with
to see
their
this?
Wacky shows.
What is it, Ralph?
Wait, is this guy going to...
Yes.
Well,
yes. He will. He's going to wear a rubber, but he can take his He can take his rubber off like a minute 45.
You see, he's changing things again.
No, not. He's gonna have. He's having sex with you.
What are you talking about that part?
But it's not gonna. It's not gonna be anything unsafe.
If the guy's clean, why does he have to wear rubber? If he's
oh, please.
Scott, how much for no rubber?
You know, how much for bare, Scott?
Scott acts as if he'll get pregnant.
Scott, the guy's got no, you know, AIDS, herpes, nothing.
Yeah. How much for bare?
Bareback.
Don't matter.
Oh, no. You're kidding.
Why? No, it probably hurt less.
Oh, come on.
How much more, Scott?
I don't understand.
Oh, you don't understand? Let's do it to you, bareback. Come on. Like, come on. I'll do it to you, bareback. Let's
Scott,
go.
How much more bear?
Oh, get out of here, Ralph. You have no money.
Another 50 G's gets you bare. Because, you know, rubber's bum me out.
Scott will have a little one of those boards like at McDonald's telling folks.
There shouldn't be a whisper in his ear.
There shouldn't be any lube involved either.
Oh, stop.
Oh, I got to have a little.
Wait a minute, Howard.
Let's try that. John, let's try it on you first and see if it works.
But Howard, what were you saying before?
If you kiss Scott's neck, I'll probably just have his own natural lube.
What, you mean a little foreplay?
The contact feels good. It feels good to me.
But why does Scott have a choice? Just come out and deliver them.
Yeah. Can somebody send him back to that stupid island he was on?
Howard, what were you saying before? A minute 45 in, the guy can do what?
Well, I'm saying he can take off his rubber and pleasure him. You know, pleasure.
Go away.
Go away. You're there. You're no. On
he's
all
got
fours.
Another 15 seconds.
You can do a Houdini.
He can do whatever he wants after the 2 minutes somewhere else.
Hey, can we put a Ned Beatty wig on him like in Deliverance?
No, we want to see his face.
Wait, what John was saying, is that a David Copperfield or a Houdini?
It's a Houdini. Do you know that is, Howard?
No.
The guy spits on Scott. No, it's okay. He spits. He hocks a loogie on Scott's back, so then Scott turns around.
Yeah, because Scott thinks it's over. I've heard it described as a David Copperfield because it's an illusion.
Look at Scott's face.
You rush this on tomorrow.
That's going to take a little doing.
It sure is.
Can it happen in Vegas now, or you don't think it?
I don't know. I'm going to make phone calls. It's going to be embarrassing for me to call my agent and even tell him this is what I want to do with my career.
It's going to be embarrassing for you to make a call.
No, it's not.
No, it's not.
The only person
I'm going to do it
embarrasses you.
And I left all the way to the bank.
You know what? You're going to waddle you. All the way.
Oh, well.
I might
limp all the way.
Wait till you see the guy we get for you.
Yeah. I like the way the wife would let him go to NASCAR school because he would enjoy that, but then he's going to get some bruises.
Well, why not? Oh, wait. Scott's wife is back on the phone. Hey, Robin.
Hi. You have to wear a condom.
Oh, yeah.
There is a condom.
It has to be checked out.
Yes.
Oh, definitely.
We've already. We wouldn't want anything happening to Scott.
He doesn't have enough life insurance.
Let me tell you something, but think about it. If we get him some guy who's unsafe, he drops dead, then you get the full $250.
Hey, just take out a little extra policy.
That's
all right.
What I'm going to have to do.
Yeah.
Robin, we assure you Scott will be wearing a condom.
No, not Scott. The other guy.
All right, Robin. Thank you.
I love how Scott's getting pimped out by his wife.
You consider this cheating, do you?
Be proud. That's your man.
This is not cheating.
Right. It's a guy.
Yeah.
Okay. Very good.
But if he turns in gay...
Yes.
What happens if he turns gay?
He's off your hand.
He's Dominic as a lawyer.
Right, it's a double payday.
That's right.
Right.
Honey, you think he's almost there? I mean, he's getting down on all fours to take it. You think he might be a little gay?
I don't know.
You're going to find out.
I know my brother-in-law said he would do it in an instant.
Well, we'd love to have you there to see it.
No, I don't want to watch it.
All right.
She just wants to order the furniture.
Yeah. Right, good for her. Thank you, Robert.
You're welcome.
Huh? Scott, you just got pimped out by your wife.
Yeah.
Very nice.
That's great.
Yeah.
Can the guy donkey punch him? Like, when you know, he's
no.
doing it's going to hit him in the back of the head?
I think this is enough of a donkey punch.
Really?
How about for an extra 50, Scott?
Scott, let me ask you something. I'll tell you what, though. You don't get your 250 if the guy can't, let's say you lock up. If you lock up.
Yeah.
You gotta relax. Yeah, you gotta relax.
And it's, the 2 minutes doesn't start until we're sure it's a go.
Oh, no.
Yeah, Mike, go ahead. You're on the air.
Here's up to top the cake. He should wear one of those straps over his head with the ball in his mouth.
Yeah, that would be nice.
No, we want to hear the noise.
Yeah, well, that's what I mean. Well, then you put it on air. Oh, you do that.
Put a ball in his mouth.
This guy, let the guy give you a nice reach around, too.
Yeah, really, where does the 2 minutes start?
Oh, I don't know.
How funny is it? Scott's going to be yelling at him to stop and stuff like that. He's going to be sweating and screaming.
Is Scott allowed to stop?
No. Oh, well, the guy can stop motion. So I can rest.
If I do a
hey, Howard.
Yeah, but then you stop the clock.
If I do a minute, do I get half of the money?
No. You got to go 2 minutes.
No.
I don't think you should be able to stop the clock.
Full out.
No, you can stop the clock.
Stop!
If Scott needs a break for a second or two, just to...
Yeah, you know those girls that do that stuff? They break some stuff.
Two full minutes straight.
Yeah.
But wait a minute. Even in Casey's pitch, he could ice down.
No. He's got to take a full 2-1.
Wait a second, though. The clock doesn't start till the guy at least...
Scott could lock up. Right. And he could have, you know, take 2 minutes to get started.
Yeah, Scott, understand. We want to see anal. Yeah.
You're gay, too.
Okay, whatever. I got to give my audience what they pay for.
It's got to be 2 full minutes.
Call your local pay-per-view provider.
I can't wait to see what name you come up with for this one.
I already got one.
What?
Jungle in the Bungle.
Oh. Rumble in the Bungle.
I got a good one. Scott gets banged.
All right, listen, we got to do some news. Scott, we got the go-ahead. I will begin to research. All right, there we go.
All right.
Good luck.
Full steam ahead.
Scott's latest humiliation.
Wow.
Should we get his song front row tickets?
Oh, stop. That poor boy.
This is actually unbelievable to me. It's almost like a dream.
I can't believe the first time he said yes, I could not believe he was saying that.
Me neither.
Go get tape this conversation Scott has with his kid.
Son.
The kid will come home and go, son, look.
You've got college coming up.
You haven't worked yet for a living. It's very hard to make money out there.
I'm not getting a raise.
Yeah, we're putting bread on the table.
Putting
there's
bread
no...
on the table and putting clothes on your back. I'll leave my ass out of this.
To your friends, and dad getting anal doesn't mean he's gay.
Didn't I always tell you I was out there busting my butt?
Some people do taxes. I do guys.
One day you'll have a family and have to take anal.
Yeah, hey, Al, there's no way that he could work here after he did it, right?
Sure.
There's no way that he could.
Why not?
Because somebody would bring it up every day.
Oh, that's the whole beauty of this.
Yeah, I mean, it does...
You can't control yourself?
It does hurt you in every argument you have. You know what I mean?
Right to it.
Al Rosenberg on the phone.
Oh.
Al?
Hey.
Hey.
This is one of the best moments I've ever heard. But I think you're going about this the wrong way, and you're not approaching Scott the right way. I think he's a romantic. How about dinner and dancing before they do it?
Well, we could make that. We could incorporate some of that. But I think the approach where America gets to vote which guy will give it to them.
I like Jill Millionaire.
I'll take Evan Marriott.
Right.
Then there's that one big moment.
Good to hear from you, Al.
Good to hear from you.
Right.
You're gonna want a big guy, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I mean, we have.
Oh, yeah.
To be.
Anyone under 9 inches need not apply.
What's Patrick Kane doing?
And Robin will get judges.
It's gonna be like a donkey.
Donkey, a mule. You know what we gotta do? We pick a guy, and then at the last minute, we switch the donkey.
No.
Oh, yeah.
Donkey climbs on Scott, kisses the door.
Oh, here, my little burrito.
Well, you know, his head will be through that sheet. He won't be able to see one.
Could be kidding me, a donkey.
You're like a mule.
You didn't say that.
Wait, you are a mule.
That guy sounds a little funny.
Wow.
Poor Scott.
I don't even know how I'm going to call Don with this and figure out.
You know, you might want to call him now.
Now, I'm going to call him off the air and show so he knows it's serious.
It's really
Do you think
serious?
It could actually happen?
Yes. Because, first of all, it's like softcore porn. No one's going to actually see the anal. They're going to see Scott's face.
Right, he'll
see,
be draped, as they say.
You know, but we'll be able to see Scott, you know, his face. We'll know what's going on.
You know, and they've done things like shown births, live births on television and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It's the same kind of thing.
We should tape my call to Don as part of the special.
The making of. The whole build-up.
The guy's going to be sweating on him and stuff.
Well, it's only 2 minutes. How much sweating will there be?
It's longer than a Tyson fight.
That's true.
Yeah.
And people pay good money for that.
I would hurry up before ABC gobbles us up.
Yeah. I don't think Scott Einziger's listening to you.
Am I hot?
Am I hot?
250 I am.
He's so funny to look at. It's going to be such a great special. I'm going to have one big camera like close up on that face. I wonder if Don will want a consulting credit on this. You know how on the E! Show, he's Don Buchwald?
Yeah.
Consultant. He always likes a title. You could be consultant.
Next on ABC, Lorenzo Lamas gets banged.
Yeah, let him pick this up. Yeah,
have his laser pointer.
Nice.
This is unbelievable.
That's going to be a great special.
Will
you ever be able to look at Scott the same way?
No. I can't look at him now.
You know, I really don't know what's going to happen. You know, it's one thing to talk about it. But after he's actually done it.
He's going to have that same dopey expression on his face.
Yeah, every time you see the look.
We're going to drive by his house.
You know what? He's already had this expression on his face like he got anal sex. Like he got screwed.
Yeah, we think that. But what does he really look like when he's getting it?
And then you think it's like one of those things in his mind. He's like, you know, it's not any different than going to the doctor or something like that. But
right.
then it's going to happen and he's going to go, oh, my God.
It's going to be so much worse than
it's gay sex. The worst. It's a prison rape.
Right. It's what happens to you in prison.
Yeah.
And, you know, what if the guy just sort of gets really excited and goes to town?
Yeah. What if Scott says, screw the 2 minutes, let's keep going?
Yeah, what if the guy starts talking dirty to him?
Well, yeah, we can't stop him once the clock stops.
You know what I want to get? I want to get, like, an ex-con to do it to him.
Why not a current con? Yeah, we get a guy. If the guy starts talking dirty, like, yeah, you little bitch. And he's,
you know what would be a kick in the ass? We find that he's been doing this all along.
Yeah, and it's nothing to him.
I told you.
I told you it wasn't any big deal.
I'm pretty sure he's never done this before.
Pull the wool over your eyes.
I can't imagine. I mean, everywhere he goes, people go to the guy that took it from 2 minutes.
Oh, can you imagine him at his bowling league?
Oh. He's going to be thrown out of the league.
Hey, laugh all you want. I'm rich.
Scott, it's Ned down at the alley. Turn in your shirt.
You're all laughing, but you wish you had that kind of cash.
I hit the lotto.
Private planes for me.
I hope he invested in something that crashed.
Oh, no, he'll invest in something. He'll be.
You know what was amazing about the way Scott answered the original question? He started out by going, are you guys kidding me? And we were, of course, going, oh, he's going to say no. He goes, of course I would. I mean, just like, Jesus.
Jeff the Drunk, what's up?
Hey, Howard.
Hey.
This is one of the funniest shows ever.
I can't believe you said no.
I can't.
Shock me.
Yeah.
Negatory.
Hey, Scott, for an extra $50,000, will you let him bukkake you?
Well, that's going to happen anyway.
It's going to be great. I can't wait.
All right, Jeff, thanks.
Later.
Jeff the Drunk,
Jeff
everybody.
Doesn't even have cable or satellite.
He's going to see it somehow.
This is
the whole country's going to be glued to the TV, literally.
This is one of the funniest shows ever. Hey, Scott.
why don't you get Bukkake? Nice.
He's Jeff the Drunk's laughing.
Jeff the Drunk.
Jeff the Drunk, you're like,
stop, you are a loser.
Well, let's call Gary the Retard and tell him he can be contestant number two.
You want to do any news?
He would do it. Yes.
It's 20 to 11.
I don't, that's crazy.
That is crazy.
Then what news story could follow this?
Well, the fact that they've been doing pelvic exams on women without their knowledge.
How do we get into that? But, you know, it's still not as good as Skype doing anal on pay-per-view.
I know, but I have to say this. Women should know. I didn't know this was happening.
Hey, now. What's happening, baby? Yeah. Good morning, everybody. Everybody's happy. Fred Norris has a smile on his face.
Hey, now.
Yeah.
Hey, now.
Marty Lang is here. Robin Quivers. All your friends from the show. Do not despair. We are here. Yeah, Robin in a good mood laughing. What are you laughing about? Wow. Why are you so happy this morning? Oh, I see. Robin, laugh once if it's because Scott's going to take anal. I guess it's not that. All right.
It is for Artie. Artie laughed.
Artie laughed.
I've been laughing for 24 hours.
So I know, it's pretty wild.
It's only what he's talking about.
I walked past one of the other guys in the engineering department. I burst into laughter. Yeah. Like they're going to be working with Anal Scott.
Anal Scott, huh? That's going to be my name, huh?
Everybody's amazed.
I'm gonna take it from a very large cock. I'm still Scott from the block. I used to have a little, but I'm gonna have a lot. No matter where I go, I'll be laughed at. I'll be on the bottom and he'll be on the top. I'm still Scott from the block. I just can't wait till my pants first drop. Now I'll be known for back and fudge.
Yeah, very good. So. Yeah, I have to tell you about my day calling my agent and trying to get this thing set up.
Yeah, you had quite a time, too, ahead of you.
I had quite a conversation, but I'm going to tell you everything about that.
All right. I'll
let that unfold, and so much to talk about. I realized yesterday we were so busy with Scott taking anal and the whole pay-per-view concept.
Yeah, we didn't practically didn't do anything else.
Yeah. We really just spent the whole show on that.
Well, once something like that falls into your lap...
People loved it.
You have to go, you know, wall to wall.
Never laughed so hard in my life. I guess some people don't even know what we're talking about.
Yeah, they weren't there when it happened, I suppose.
Can you believe some people don't listen to the whole 5 hours of this show?
Some people are sleeping right now and they plan to tune in later.
Shame. Shame. No. Shame. Well, it has captured the imagination of America. Yesterday, Scott saying that he would take anal from a man. I don't even know what other kind of anal he could take. But he would take anal from a man for $250,000, $250,000. And all I know is I'm in the middle of putting together a pay-per-view special. We got a great show for you today, actually. In addition to me telling you the whole aftermath of that conversation, we have a new game. And I can't even say what it is until we play.
Okay,
we have a new game that I think you're going to like.
That you can't even say the name of.
Yeah, because it'll ruin it.
Will you tell us after we play
the game?
I'll tell you right as we're about to begin playing the game. Right. Sandra Bernhardt is going to stop by.
Okay.
Wow.
Yeah. And who else? I guess that's it. But, you know, we have a lot to go through today. We have so many things. If you saw my desk, Robin, you would see millions of tapes. Voicemails, unbelievable amounts of material that have to be gotten to. All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be back right after these words.
Howard, if you get caught red-handed banging on K-Rock floor,
shame on you.
On ETV, you make sure that Robin ain't in that boot looking at you. You dig? Dig that? Wasn't me.
All right, you know I came in and I saw Howard Stern just banging on the K-Rock floor.
Wah, wah.
After this, he was butt naked with a pretty girl on all fours. How could he forget that Robin was in that extra seat? Bet her jaws hit the floor when he told her it wasn't me.
Hey, she knows that you're really not right for this. Wow. I never used to see you make the gigolo flex.
Crazy.
As Mario said, mm-hmm. Baby, you in the complex. Seeing is believing, so you better check your specs. Right. You know she had to bring out whatever things are from the past.
They believe.
Had a little evidence, you better rope him out. Quick, my answer, no hope it's out. But if she back out, you know you better run fast.
Cut, left it.
Left.
You're listening to the Howard Stern Show.
This is Radio Shock Jock, Howard Stern.
Hey-o.
Hey now.
Hey now.
Hey now.
Fire.
Hey now.
Fire.
Yeah. Do it.
A 21 comes to lose.
A friend of mine went to that AC/DC concert at Roseland. He said that
yeah.
He still can't hear. His ears are like blown out.
It was really loud, but they sounded great. Jumping around like an idiot for an hour and a half.
Fire! Yeah, yeah! Like a Roseland!
New York City.
Yeah, we in New York City, yeah. Anybody out there drinking a beer? Who needs a beer?
Did he say that?
Yeah.
About a million times. Anybody out there drinking a beer?
Yeah.
You know, at some point, you know, he just says that because he knows the crowd likes it.
Well, yeah.
There's nothing sincere.
He says it every concert.
Nothing sincere about it.
At one point, he mentioned two people that were there from Australia,
yeah.
And everybody in the crowd was dead quiet, so he had to go back to, yeah, but it's nothing like New York City!
Whatever will get a reaction.
I read Billy Joel stopped by the AC/DC concert to say hi to AC/DC, but he split after like a song or two with some hot brunette.
Oh, really?
That's what it said in the paper.
He had a girlfriend.
Maybe that was it. I don't know. I don't know. Who knows who the hopper devil? You know, one time when I first got single, I went with my daughter to some concert.
Right.
We went to just hang out at the Hammerstein Ballroom, uh-huh. Or Hammerstein, whatever it is. Hammerstein is too Jewish.
Hammerstein Ballroom.
Yeah, the Hammerstein Ballroom.
Change it to Stein.
We went to see, like, the All-Stars, whatever those guys were, with that great song they do.
Hey, now, you're an all-star.
No, not those guys.
Oh, you're talking about that.
Low Fidelity All-Stars?
Low Fidelity All-Stars. Thank you, Baba, Baba Booby.
Oh, I know the song you're talking. It's like a techno.
Turns out, the guy just gets on stage and plays a disc, like a record.
Oh, really?
Yeah, there's no band. He doesn't sing. It totally sucked. I mean, I love that song by Low Fidelity All-Stars, but the show blows. But these kids all do X. And they were just standing there, like, staring at him, and, like, he would just play records.
Yeah, yeah.
Because he's, like, a DJ.
Does
he play good records?
I don't know. You know, it was stuff I didn't know. And then, like, the kids just stare at him. And then, like, if his buddy came up to light a cigarette, and the crowd goes crazy.
Oh, my goodness.
So you know they're high as a kite.
Right.
And I didn't even realize they were high. I was, like, so out of it. But anyway, I was there with my daughter. And the guy in page 6 wrote the next day that I was there with a hot brunette.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Like, holy cow.
That's creepy.
Yeah. There's a story now. Yeah.
You know, I saw.
And I made a point of telling the publicist there because I know they all call the. I go, I'm waiting for my daughter.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, didn't matter.
I saw Richard Johnson at the AC/DC.
Yeah?
Yeah, he came up to me.
Did you go, fire?
Give me a free drink card. I said, Richard, fire! Page 6, yeah! Page 6, little daddy D's.
He had free drink cards?
There was free drink cards that people were passing out, I guess. I never got one.
But how's that work?
He had one and he gave me one. Free drink ticket.
Nice.
I guess he worked it out because he's press or something.
Yeah, probably somebody gave them to him.
When you get the free drink, though, you leave a tip for the bartender, don't you? Or you just get the free drink and you split.
I think you just throw the ticket out. I didn't use it.
Right.
I was up where there was paid drinks, and I was tipping all night.
I'm not drinking during the week anymore.
Well, I mean, you have in the past? Really?
Yeah. No, I was getting into it.
Well, like wine or something?
Wine, a little vodka.
Vodka? Yeah.
I'm not doing it anymore.
Well, yeah, not since he's gotten sick.
Yeah. No, I'm not doing it even after I get healthy.
We'll see.
No. You know what happens?
I've heard your promises before.
No. You know me. I'm very disciplined when it comes to that crap.
You know what happens is yesterday I slept all afternoon. I had no choice. And then I got up and had dinner and I couldn't get back to bed till like about 11. So it screws you up.
You're napping too much.
No, but he had gone out to the AC/DC concert and was out all night practically.
Yeah, I don't usually nap that much in the afternoon. I had to. I had no choice. I fell asleep till like 5:30.
Yeah, no.
He's a completely different color today.
Yeah.
Exactly. I feel good.
I went to the doctor yesterday because I've been having this lingering cold thing. They took blood.
Uh-huh.
They chest x-rayed me. Because I had just had a full exam about 2 months ago, 3 months ago. I had to go for a physical.
Yeah, I remember.
I did everything but the colonoscopy. But he even said to me, when are you coming in for the colonoscopy? And I was like, I don't know. Why don't you just call it what it is? When are you coming in to have a camera up shoved up your ass?
We're going to do it on pay-per-view.
We need to take a picture of your colon.
Yeah.
Wee. Tell your colon to say cheese.
So anyway, I went and got a full physical from my man, Bob Baker, Dr. Bob Baker, who's such a nice guy. And he did the chest x-ray. He does everything. And lo and behold, you know, nothing there. He said he wouldn't even take an antibiotic. He just said...
Just live through it.
And I said, is there any chance... Because Pat said to me I could be allergic to my dog. He said, is there any chance I'm allergic to the dog? He goes, you know what? If the thing lingers for another 2 months... I would say we might test that, but I don't think you are. I said, and besides, I lived with a dog on Long Island for years. I never had
an allergy. Certain, you know, it could be certain types of dogs.
Yeah, he says it's in the dander.
Yeah.
So, but I don't think that's it. And I just don't. I don't know why. I just don't.
You don't want to.
I don't want to think that. I don't want to have that. Because even Beth said, would you take pills? I go, no.
So what happens to poor
Bianca? No, she'll be fine.
I mean, if you are allergic, what would happen to Bianca?
I'm not allergic.
But answer my question.
What would happen?
Yeah.
I'd keep her in a different part of the apartment or something. I don't know what I would do. I don't know. I would do something.
Really?
Yeah, I love the dog.
You'll throw that dog out the window.
All right. I'll put her to sleep. That's all. We drop the dog off in the subway. I drop her off with a drifter who lives in a teepee.
There you go.
No, I don't know. I don't think that's it at all, actually. I'm not the allergic type, and I don't have any allergies.
Whatever type that is.
You know the type. You can spot them. They're always with busy bodies.
With stuff.
Yeah.
If that is the case, I know a guy who can get rid of the dog for you. $200.
Oh.
Didn't he get rid of Robert Blake's wife? Or was that Robert Blake? Well, they're talking about letting Robert Blake out for bail. They're actually going to consider it.
Well, that's what the judge has to consider after this hearing.
Yeah. So anyway, he said it could be that if it lingers for like 2 months or something, but... He doesn't suspect that that's what it is. And he just said to me, take some Robitussin. It's like an expectorant. Gets all that crap up. And I'm not even going to do it. He said, you don't even need to do that. Just, he says, go back to the gym, start working out, and forget about it.
Right. Move around.
Move around a little bit. Move, you know, you're getting into a funk.
So you definitely don't have bronchitis or anything like that.
No, nothing. Right. It's just the weirdest thing. I'm sleeping a lot and, you know. And I don't even have a cough, really. It's just when I breathe in, it tickles. And I just said, you know what? I think I'm cuckoo.
Well, that we know. That's for sure.
So, that was my medical update. Then, I put off calling my agent about the Scott the Engineer thing.
Yeah, how long did it take you to get up the guts to make
it? I can't wait to hear that.
I was just hoping that, like, somebody would tell him about it and...
He'd call you?
Yeah.
Does he not listen to the show as well?
No, he hears it. You know, he says he doesn't listen, but then I talk to him and he goes, hey, I heard what Fred said and Robin said and...
Right, he sometimes hears things.
Yeah, somehow he gets word or hears or whatever, you know. He's another guy who doesn't listen, but meanwhile he listens.
There's a lot of people like that, I've found.
They don't
since
know
I've been
they
on the
listen.
Show.
Yeah. Yeah, they don't know they listen.
Yeah.
I think it's disturbing to them that they listen. So, I don't know, like Scott, you know, dropped a bombshell yesterday on the air during the big game, would you do anal or not? And he said that he would do anal with a man for $250,000.
Right. I mean, yeah, no hesitation.
Yeah. He says it's 5 years' salary.
What a thing!
And we were all like, we couldn't believe it yesterday. We spent 2 hours on it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it stopped the whole show. He stopped all the big things from happening because we couldn't believe it. We couldn't believe it.
People, I mean, they were screaming they couldn't believe it so much.
That's right. So, anyway, like, I drove around like half the day and stuff. Talent, people were talking to me about it. I was talking about it. Everyone was talking about it. Everyone agreed they would pay for it on pay-per-view.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you'd have to see it.
Yeah. So, you know, and they liked the whole idea that guys would line up and we would judge their penis size.
And America would choose.
America would choose who would give Scott anal. And it's going to be some big-ass guy.
Yeah. We're not going to let him off easy.
No.
Yeah, nobody attractive.
It's 250 G's. It's a lot of cake.
So I wanted to do it here in the studio and get a sponsor to do it. Tom backed out of that.
Yeah, he wasn't hearing anything.
And so I said, well, I would do it on pay-per-view. It would be a great special. My audience would pay. We'd get to $250,000. We'd have a party. Only problem is, like, and I was thinking about it in my mind. I was like, well, okay, we're not going to see any insertion. Scott's going to be, we're going to see his face, and maybe we'll see the guy's butt who's delivering the goods, who's delivering the B-52.
Well, actually, you could drape it so that you could see the guy.
Mm-hmm.
Practically all of the guy.
Right.
And, you know, the top of Scott.
Right. Just seeing his face. You know. So, and I was thinking on Queer as Folk, which you watch, mm-hmm. they show probably more.
Last night I watched my episode of Queer as Folk this week, and this guy was in a club, and you could actually, you know, this guy was wearing tighty whities.
Yeah.
It was an underwear party.
Yeah.
And this guy was wearing tighty whities, and you could see hands
on the crotch
toward bulges, you know, like right on bulges.
Yeah, you'd actually see less in this special
right.
than that. You see less.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You see a lot on cable.
I mean, you'd see men's penises, but they would, you know, they'd be being judged. They wouldn't be in the act of sex.
Right.
Right. So, in terms of pornography, it's soft core at the best.
Right.
And then somebody said, well, isn't it illegal? And I go, there's gay porno. Nobody seems to have a problem with that. There's all kinds of gay porno.
Has it ever been on pay-per-view? This could be
Yeah, but it's not even that. It's not even insertion. So
it's got to be legal.
Well, it is.
Yeah. Because people go, but well, you're going to have to go to Vegas to do it. I go, Vegas? I could do it right here in an apartment in Jersey.
Wait a minute. Let me ask you something.
Yeah.
Because I always have this question about the Cinemax After Dark things and all that stuff. And that softcore
right.
porn.
Yeah.
They're not really having sex. They're simulating having sex. Is that true?
They're simulating, yeah.
All right. So you can't say this is not insertion. You're just not seeing.
Right. You're not seeing the insertion.
Right.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Right.
No, actually, those things are shot as regular pornos, and then they shoot them again. There's probably insertion.
Oh,
there could
okay.
be.
See, that's what yeah. my question was.
Yeah, there could be. It depends on the porno.
All right.
I would have to see the porno.
All
but
right.
Yeah, right. So then that means there's sex happening. You just can't see it, which
right.
is what we're doing.
Right.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
It's a legal
bind here.
So I put off calling my agent for a long time. By the time I called him, he was like, yeah, what's this going on? He goes, someone called me. Someone told me. And I was like, oh, hey.
He didn't call you, so it can't be good.
So I laid out the whole special. I go, picture this. Black screen. Suddenly we come up on, and I don't even know what we call this thing. Like, if it's American Idol, is it American Anal? You know, American Anal. Tonight, America decides who will give a straight man anal. A man who has agreed to receive anal for $250,000. Here's your host, Howard Stern. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How are you? Maybe I'll even spike my hair blonde and try
yeah,
to look
Ryan
young.
Ryan Seacrest?
Yeah, I'll be like Ryan Seacrest. And then I'll go, tonight we have a man who has agreed to have anal for $250,000. And then I throw it to a package. be a 7-minute piece on the life of Scott the Engineer. Everyone would be good and depressed. Interviews, everything. Bam, back to me. Now let me introduce you to our judges. Sitting to my left, Robin Quivers.
Hello, America.
Brian Johnson of AC/DC.
Hello, America, yeah! Fire!
And Stuttering John.
Hi.
Hi. We have a lot of famous people in the audience. In the front row is Scott's wife and son.
There's the family. Yeah, the supportive family right there.
Then we cut backstage to Scott, who's like a boxer. He's in a room. He's preparing whatever he's doing. You know,
he's
we
in
just
a robe.
You know, Scott, how you feel? I do a 1-minute interview. then we just cut to a picture of the United Nations. Just for the hell of it. Kofi Annan or somebody like that.
Yeah, a riot going out.
No!
By the way, America, while we're deciding who gives Scott anal, just realize there's a potential war in Iraq.
You know, what we should do.
Because we'll still be debating then whether to invade or not.
Yeah, but some terrorist dude talking about how the American culture is.
Yeah, then we'll go to Saddam Hussein or Osama bin Laden giving a lecture on how American society is ruining the world.
Right.
Then we come out. Mark Harris says the Pledge of Allegiance.
Ah.
Something like that, or the or to National Anthem.
I don't know if we can live through it.
Before we get to Scott's anal, we have to pick a man to deliver the goods. Bring out 10 guys. Porno stars, listeners of ours, everyone. Judges decide. We talk to each contestant, and then a man is selected by America. We do another interview with the judges, and while that's going on, we tally the votes. Very rapid vote. Very quick vote. And then we go to the main event.
And now.
It's time for me to be...
with Michael Buffer.
Yeah. Let's get ready to get ready. Let's get ready for some hot anal. Let's get ready to get ready. Scott gets behind the curtain. We see his face. Camera close up. We go behind the curtain so we can see that there's actual penetration, and when the penetration begins, we time out 2 minutes. And then I imagine it's just a lot of Scott sweating and...
And grimacing. To start the clock once everything's, you know, in place.
Yes. It'll be amazing. Unreal, huh?
Oh, my goodness. So what did Don say when you finished this pitch?
He said, I don't believe it. You know, it's unbelievable. You sure Scott wants to do this kind of thing? I said, yeah. He goes, the pay-per-view people called me yesterday, wanted to know what we had up our sleeve.
Oh, geez.
So I said, well, why don't you get back to him?
Up our sleeve. Yeah.
Vinny Favalli told me he called some of his pay-per-view people, so I don't even know what he found out. What'd you find out?
Here's what I found out. Pretty interesting. First of all, they could do it pretty quickly. They could get you in 11 million homes pretty much on a dime. If you decide you want to do it, they can have it within days.
Did you tell them what the subject
was? I went into great detail. Here's what I found out. First of all, some of their porno channels, the hardcore pay-per-view ones, like $10 for an hour, they show everything except anal. But the genius of the idea is you won't show anal, so they're fine with it the way you set it up.
Oh, great.
Yeah. Also, you won't have a problem showing the penis in the context of judging the different penises.
Right.
Okay.
The guys who... Right.
It's a little out of context. The two things they bring to the table is they get you in 11 million homes, and normally you get a ton of marketing from them. That's what they do for their part of the split. The problem with this is they said they would have to leave all the marketing to you because they have no idea how to market this.
Oh, I see. But can I run a commercial, let's say, on their network?
No, see, well, that's the problem. I mean, you probably would have to have it approved. I mean, because we were trying to figure out how do you sell this thing to really convey what it is. And you know,
well, I'll go on Letterman and Leno and
that way. But normally they do promos for pay-per-view events within the different cable channels, and they said in this case, but if they didn't market it and left it to you, then that means you can get more money. They wouldn't go 50-50 with you like they normally do.
Yeah.
So that's good for you, because then...
What do you mean? They give me a better cut?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Oh.
I know that's always been the deal-breaker, and they would certainly be willing to discuss that because they know that they would do zero marketing. They just... She said they're just giving you the pipeline.
Wow.
Yeah.
So we would get the pipeline, and then Scott would get the pipeline.
Everybody's getting the pipe. I said, what?
You're going to give me the pipe. So is that pay-per-view, or is that...
It would be pay-per-view. They're in 11 million homes.
Whoa. Is that DirecTV?
It would be DirecTV, correct.
Oh, all right. That's just DirecTV.
But Howard, that's a pretty good cross-section of the entire...
Yeah, but like if my fans in Cleveland want to see Scott get anal... What, like, are they, is DirecTV on in all the
markets? Yeah. They pretty much could penetrate throughout the whole country, every market.
I don't know about that. I've checked into that before. It's like, well.
It's just that how many people have satellite as opposed to cable?
That's right. Like in New York.
There's a lot of people. You know what you could do? Remember the old Ali Frazier fights where they did it in movie theaters as
well?
Simulcast it?
Yeah.
Remember that?
Yeah, we could do that, but
you
know,
DirecTV could sponsor that, maybe.
Maybe. I don't know if people want to go to a movie theater to watch anal.
Right. And what time of the day are we doing that?
Kind of thing you might want to watch in your house. I don't know if you want to be in a movie theater.
But
you know what, Howard? You can't wait. You got to do it, because if you wait, it'll never happen. 1% of 11 million is still a lot of money, you know?
I don't even know that that matches up with our markets. I got to get the other pay-per-view, the ones that people use on cable and... A lot of people don't have satellite, dude.
Yeah, but a lot of people know someone who does. It's like 6 degrees of separation. I'm sure you can cover almost your entire audience.
But the point is, then you have 50 people watching for one admission fee.
You charge a higher fee because it is a big event. It is a big event.
But people have parties for stuff like this.
Yeah. All right, so DirecTV has no problem doing it.
She said she would definitely take it to her bosses. It's something that they find very interesting.
Actually, if you were...
Definitely interesting.
If I was... conversation on the phone.
Embarrassing.
If you were a guy in the audience, I don't know if I'd be comfortable watching this alone. might be too creepy.
It's going to be funny.
She wanted, you know, to know exactly how the show would play out, because, like, well, it's 2 minutes of anal, but it's a nice lead-up to it.
Yeah, I mean, there's packages.
Yeah.
I mean, I think the whole special would be 45 minutes to an hour.
Yeah, it's almost as if you know you're going to have a 2-minute fight at the end.
Right.
You know?
Yeah, I mean, and Tyson, you know you're going to have a 39-second fight with those bums he fights.
Yeah,
so.
That's right. There's no bad fight at the end of this.
They seem to be able to drag that out.
Well,
unless we
Tyson
had some...
doesn't really wind up on pay-per-view very often. He
that's true. Well, there was a time when Tyson was hot that he did end up on pay-per-view.
Yeah, and they'd have 5 other fights before him. Because
you know what you could do, Howard? Could you sell it to Showtime after the pay-per-view like they do the normal fights? You know, it has one platform on pay-per-view, and then...
Well, I tell you what, I would sell the whole thing to Showtime. That way everyone could get it, and then... But
and Showtime could handle the pay-per-view.
Yeah, because Showtime just gives us like $10 million, it'll be no problem.
Right.
And then we'll cover all our costs. Including Scott's $250,000 bonanza.
Including the stitches.
Yeah. This is a very big event. I mean, this is going to be one of the highest tune-ins in history.
That's all everyone was talking about yesterday.
Yeah. It's big. It is big. I mean, as depraved as it is, it's big.
There's a lot of interest.
And you know what's weird? A lot of people do this every day because they're gay. It's not a big deal for certain people, but if you're not gay, wow.
No. Yeah. And in our show's universe, this is a big deal. In fact, I'm wondering, like, what happened when Scott went home? Did his son say anything? Or
well,
his wife?
What everybody was saying, is he out of his mind? His son will
school.
Oh, man.
And the bowling team, what about them?
I mean, yeah. Like, even Ronnie.
Neighbors.
Ronnie said to me, what are you doing?
Yeah, Ronnie was out of his mind over this.
A lot of people couldn't believe Scott's wife gave him permission to do it.
She sounded like she did.
Oh, here's Scott. He can tell us what happened. I better not find out, Scott, that you've been getting anal all along. That, like, you're kind of a swinger.
No big deal to you.
Yeah, I mean, are you a swinger?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
This guy's got a bit of a weird history. Have you ever received anal?
No.
No.
Never been near a man.
You ever give it?
No anal here.
So what happened when you went home? Did your wife, like, say, are you crazy? But she said on the air, there's no problem. Did you
heard what she said.
But did you discuss it with her? Yeah. Did she bring it up?
Let me tell you. The money is already spent.
Really?
Yeah, no problem.
On what? Junk?
Yeah. What? No. She had no problem with it.
You know you're humorless? Do you know that? Do you know you have no ability to have a conversation?
She had no problem with it.
I've always said I think anyone could do radio. You can't.
She had no problem with it.
She had no problem with it. And like, what do you say? You go, you really want to talk seriously about this? Or what do you think? Or, I mean, how's it go? At what point does she bring it up? As soon as you walk in the door?
Yeah. She's just like, you know, so what's going on? I go, you heard, you know, on the air what happened. Nothing else happened. And, you know, you're okay with it. So we'll go ahead with it.
Is she bored out of her mind living with you?
Absolutely.
I mean, because I'm bored talking to you.
Absolutely.
It's going to be unbelievable. I'm glad you're going to. And maybe for once in your life, you'll have some energy.
No.
Yeah, you know what? I think this gave her something to talk to him about.
Yeah. Yeah. This is probably the first discussion they've had in months. So, what happened when your son came home? Did you have to explain to him what's going on?
She explained to him.
She talked to your son.
This is, she picked him up from school and explained to him.
Did he know anything about it?
No.
Had he heard?
No.
So she got him in the car.
Right.
And what did she say to him?
She said, I have to talk to you about something your father's going to do. What do you think about it?
So whoa, back up. What your father's going to do. And she explained that you're going to receive anal on pay-per-view.
That's right.
How do you explain that to you?
At first he thought it was a strap-on.
Oh, like from a woman.
Yeah.
Right. But she said, no, it's from a man.
Right.
And then your son said...
And did she explain that it's $250,000 and you guys need the money?
Yes.
Well, I want to know what the son's reaction was. Did he hear about the money and everything right together, or...
Yeah, he heard about everything.
And what was his reaction?
His reaction was, this is what you do. You do the first 2 minutes, and then every minute beyond that, you ask for another $150,000.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
You go up to 5 minutes, you get $750,000.
Can't you be an agent?
Well, we need is 2 minutes, dude. Because I think you're going to be crying.
But then you can bet. Then you can bet to see how long I go.
Scott will be there for 3 minutes.
I can't. Everybody is willing for Scott to do this.
And number two, his band wants to challenge the losers. That's another condition.
Howard, yeah.
There's no condition.
We're sitting in there, we're listening to this, and John just goes, Scott's family is the monsters.
Yeah, how could they all just be willing to give up Scott's butt?
I've been with you for 18 years, and I thought I knew you, and I clearly don't.
No. Nobody knows me.
Nobody Scott, wants to know.
Nobody. Out, nope.
You?
What?
You wouldn't back out at the last minute, would you?
Is that a pun?
No, it's not.
Well, hey, that's another thing. Don't waste time. I mean,
yeah, this is, if we get this all set up, you can't back out.
Deal.
If you back out, man, there's got to be a penalty.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It wouldn't be big enough.
Doing it is just penalty enough.
Scott's family is the Munsters, but with no Marilyn.
I can't believe it. This is great. This is...
So,
it boggles
So then mind. Your wife explained everything to your son.
Right.
And when he came home, did he, like, rush over you? Dad, I heard you're going to make a lot of money? Or
no, he was just like, you know.
You. What did he say to you?
He was just like, nothing.
Did he say, like, are you gay?
No.
Wow. All right, so this is a go.
He said, yeah, of course.
All right, all I got to do is hope that I can get the pay-per-view people to go along with it.
Absolutely.
All right. Wow.
Still can't believe it.
Can we take out insurance in case Scott regains his sanity and backs out?
Yeah, there's got to be something.
You realize you're going to be on television. The camera will be on your face.
Right.
While you receive anal.
On my face.
From a gay man.
Right.
And we're going to find the largest man in America.
Oh, I do want to auction off my forehead as a billboard. Any sponsor that's willing to pay, you know, for some air, for some time.
All right.
You know, 1-800-TRIM-SPAR on my head. How much is that worth?
Yeah, I'm sure they want to be associated with this.
Right, well, you're in that position.
So, you realize, I mean, we're going to see the look of pain on you. You realize that this is going to be unbelievably painful.
It could be. Wait.
You don't know what it's going to be. What if he
it's
just
2 minutes.
What if he enjoys it?
Yeah, I may enjoy it. You never
what
know.
If you're like, hey, give me another 2 minutes for free.
There you go. Hey, you never know.
Or leave us alone.
It might be fun. I might not want to stop.
You're gay, dude.
Whatever you want to think.
Okay.
That's all.
Any guy who would do this is gay.
I mean, you know.
Obviously, I don't do it, you know, in my private life for nothing, but for a chance to,
Make $250,000, you'll do it.
Man, like you said yesterday, it doesn't come along every day. And who the hell is going to give me that?
So he's lucky he never went to prison.
That's right.
By the way, a lot of people don't even know how this all came about. What happened was Casey did a bit where we would bet, would a guy do anal for money?
Mm-hmm.
And we called Gary the retard, Scott.
And Jeff the drunk.
And Jeff the drunk. And we all said, no way Jeff the drunk would do it. And he, of course, didn't. And the other shocker was Gary the retard.
We thought he wouldn't.
Where's the Gary the retard call? I'm looking for it. Hey, guys, you got that? You got that case?
Yeah.
Yeah, let me have that.
Yeah,
thank you.
Baby.
I was shocked by this.
Casey.
Hey, Casey, what's up?
How you doing, my friend?
I'm just waiting for you to try to call me. I hadn't heard from you in a long time. I wonder what happened.
Yeah, no, we're still working on the Vegas thing, but... Gary, I'm calling for a different reason today.
What?
Okay, this might be a strange reason to call, but I figured I'd throw it at you, okay?
What? Go ahead.
All right. There's a guy, we were talking about it in the meeting, and he's offering $250,000 to any member of the WAC Pack that we choose.
Right.
And we figured that you always are looking for money and need some money, so we figured...
Yes, I do.
Yeah,
I'm
you need money.
For money.
Yeah, so this is $250,000.
Right.
Okay, but the only thing is, what's happened, his name is Michael J. Cox.
Right.
And he's going around, he's writing a book about what it's like to have anal with straight men. Now,
right.
We know you're a straight guy.
I'm a straight guy.
I know. So what it's called is 2 minutes of anal.
Right.
What would happen is he would give you anal for 2 minutes.
Anal for 2 minutes?
Yeah, and he'd give you $250,000 for it. Now, you don't have to be on videotape.
For 2 minutes?
Yeah.
With the guy?
Right.
I never done it with the guy before.
I know. That's what he's writing the book about.
Oh.
Well, you know, what happens is, you know, he'll wear a condom.
Right.
So it's up to you. I mean, what do you think you would do?
I never had sex with the guy before. I'd rather have sex with a woman, you know what I mean?
I know, so that's why he's paying, because he knows you're a straight guy.
Right.
And he offered $250,000.
That much?
Yeah, that's $250,000.
Ooh, like I said, I never had sex with a guy before.
Right, we know that, that's why.
Right. Oh, That would be kind of strange. I never had fun with the guy before, you know.
Right, but would you have sex with a man for 2 minutes for $250,000?
I'd try it and see what happens.
So you would do it?
Yeah.
Wow. I was shocked.
I was too.
It's a sad day.
I'm wondering, has he ever actually had full sex with a woman?
I don't think so.
I don't think so.
I don't know, but I just
wonder. He keeps saying, I never had from God. He's never had from anybody.
There's some weird, retarded debate going on in his head, and I only wish we could get in there. And,
yeah, I wish he could verbalize.
But does he think $250,000 is $10 million, or what does he think it is?
Right. Does he think he'll be like a lottery winner with $100 million?
Wayne Siegel, you're on the air.
Hey, how? Hi, Robin.
Hi.
Why don't you see if you could sell this, like, in Atlantic City? Well, you do like the boxing thing, except you put them behind the scenes in the concert. You know how they have those big screens?
You make it live?
You make it live.
Maybe that would be easier. I wouldn't have to go through pay-per-view, but...
A little concert action.
You know, like a
right,
live concert.
You do it in Atlantic City, you could sell the tickets. I'm sure everybody would pay $75 a ticket for this.
But I need a stadium like the size of Nassau Coliseum.
You probably need a stadium the size of the state of New York.
I mean, I need a big stadium if I'm going to do it, like Giant Stadium.
Well, what about the rest of the world that wants to see this?
Right. But then it would sound like you don't have to go through all that hassle because they would arrange for it.
That's true. You know, then we wouldn't even need pay-per-view.
That's true.
Although, I could make a separate deal with DirecTV and say, well, if you guys want to offer this to your people, DirecTV customers...
Right, you could do that. I'm simply saying, yeah, we shouldn't cut the rest of the country out.
I could videotape it and just sell it as a video afterwards.
That's true, too. Yeah. But, you know, there's something to be said for being there the moment it happened.
Well, we are going to Vegas. I could probably put it together. I got to just find a stadium that holds 80,000 people. It's got to look like Gladiator.
80,000.
I need 80,000.
It's like 800,000.
How many people does Detroit Stadium hold? In Detroit, when I used to go to the football games, it looked like there were 80,000.
Silverdome.
Pontiac Silverdome
probably holds about 70,000 people.
That's what I'm talking about. 70,000 people.
I think they just built a new one, right?
Yeah. I used to go see games at Pontiac Silverdome with 70,000.
Does Vegas have anything like that? Vegas doesn't even have any teams.
You know, the guys just gave me a note. The Taj Mahal holds 7,000. We're not talking about 7,000 people here.
Right. You're talking 70,000 people.
We need 70,000 seater. There are going to be people flying in from all over the country to see this guy get anal.
Without a doubt. I mean, you've got to find a place in the landing strip for planes.
It's going to be the biggest event in Las Vegas history.
This is like the Olympics. People will come from everywhere.
Yeah.
Giant Stadium will give you a capacity about 77,000. Or, if you wanted to have some real fun, we go up to Syracuse. The Carrier Dome holds over 100,000 people.
Is that right?
Really?
Yeah.
But I think Giant Stadium is easier to get to.
I do, too.
You're darn right about that.
So why don't I just rent Giant Stadium for the day?
The home that Bruce built.
Your attention, please, ladies and gentlemen.
Have that bad organ music.
Now receiving anal. Scott the engineer.
Next time.
We have beer, all concession stand, commemorative T-shirt, everything.
Right, the house that they built.
Batter up.
Can I just tell you something?
Why not do it at the Giant Stadium with big giant screens?
I think that's exactly the way to go.
Hmm.
If you charge, say you charged.
Is that outdoors?
Yes.
Yeah. But
oh boy.
That's all right.
Well, we're doing it in the spring.
All right. I'm thinking about right now.
No rain date.
And let me just go, you're right. If it's raining,
for my butt.
If that's raining, will it stop you at all?
No.
Put on a poncho and watch the sun.
No.
Maybe that'll be.
And
we could have
rain.
We could have tailgate parties and everything
the whole
going on.
Parking
tailgate parties.
Daddy D's.
Daddy D's to be a dead cheap now, John Stadium. Yeah.
Can I say something? You know who's sort of bummed out about this whole thing?
Who?
Tom.
Why?
He feels we're talking about it too much, and it's funny because
Shut up.
I said, didn't you think we were going to be talking about it first thing this morning? And he goes, I was actually hoping Scott would come to his senses. He never imagined Scott's whole family would say, let's get it on.
Tom's insane. Tom still doesn't know what radio show he hired over here.
Tom sat in here while we were discussing this the whole time yesterday. If you could add a camera on the look on his face.
Yeah,
the whole time.
He just refused to laugh.
Oh, my God.
I think he just wishes it would go away.
Well, I don't care what he wishes.
After it's done.
What he wishes.
Scott looking so proud over there.
I wish he'd go away. Scott, you're finally getting the attention of the world.
Scott's a star.
We will do it at Giant Stadium. Let me think.
Yeah.
All right.
Welcome to Yankee Stadium.
Oh, my goodness.
I just don't know if it can be mic'd properly. And
oh, it can.
Oh, yeah. I mean, doesn't it echo? It'll be like,
Yeah, it'll be like Lou Gehrig's last speech.
Today, I consider myself.
If you want, it's very, very inexpensive. You can broadcast on a low radio frequency. It's probably going to bring the headphones.
Today, I consider myself.
Can we broadcast it on a low radio frequency?
Yeah, that could be done. And you still want to bring headphones. You tune to like 88 and.
Today, I become a fag. 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 Fag.
I consider myself the luckiest man in the world.
Today.
I consider myself the sorest engineer.
I think we can do Giant Stadium.
Yeah, what about the post-game wrap-up?
You know who we'll get? You know, I just spoke to you yesterday. We'll get Greg Gumbel to come on back.
That'd be beautiful. He's terrific. Professional.
Jingleberries.
He can call anything.
How about Marv? He loves this kind of kinky stuff.
Marv would be the perfect man for the job.
I think Marv's looking to clean up his image.
Yeah, I think that he'll stay away from us, unfortunately.
Wayne Siegel from Legend Porsche Audi Saab. Thank you.
Buying a sponsorship, aren't you?
Wayne, I'll
buy a sponsorship.
Excellent.
I mean, forget the fear factor. This is take it in the brown factor.
Well, actually, Wayne, like any sporting event, we will have banners and things that you can buy.
Absolutely.
As an advertiser.
Rear factor.
No, rear factor.
You'll see, like, legend.
It's the queer factor.
Maybe we should let guys like Wayne have a luxury suite. You know, for a better client.
I'll be selling luxury
suites.
Oh,
you want to see this from the sky?
I have to get some of the back end. I'm sorry.
You're getting all of the back end. Yeah. All right, thank you.
Need merchandising.
All right, I'll see you later, guys.
All right,
merchandising. Buy a Scott Getting Banged T-shirt.
Yeah.
Wow. Actually, what we could do with Wayne, a little promotion. We hide the keys to a brand new Porsche in Scott.
Ah.
And then a listener rummages around to find
it. Try to find it. The treasure hunt.
It starts. Gary Garber, our reporter, you're on the air.
Yeah, Howard, in Vegas, they have a stadium called Boys Stadium that holds about 35,000 people.
Boys Stadium?
Boys
Stadium. See, if we took this on tour, Scott would just take anal in 10 different cities.
$250,000 a pop.
That's right.
Coming to St. Louis.
Hey, Howard, aren't you shocked by how nonchalant Scott is about this?
Let's see him that night.
Yeah, I really don't believe he understands the gravity.
I bet you he vomits.
Scott, you're nuts, man. You're crazy, man.
I'm definitely out of my mind. There's no doubt about it.
You must be on Prozac or something.
Yeah, are you on drugs?
Yeah, is he gonna,
have you thought about the reality?
Reality? No.
No, seriously, have you thought about it? Are you going to be, like, there? There's going to be a stadium full of people screaming and yelling. Well, and, then you're gonna receive
first
anal.
Of all, there was never a stadium until just 2 minutes ago.
Well, we got to get you the money somehow.
Yeah, somehow we got to come up with the
box. Stadium.
You keep making it bigger and bigger.
Well, I got to come up with money for you.
What? I would think pay-per-view would be enough to come up with the money.
Oh, no.
That would be great looking
at you. You'd rather be pay-per-view?
Use your brain. What would you rather have, 77,000 people see you or pay-per-view?
Millions.
He's going to put it on pay-per-view anyway, video, if he does it. I mean, you know, what
don't
do you
worry
think
about
it's
it.
Just going to be 77,000 people?
Mike Tyson doesn't worry about where he's fighting. He worries about just the fight.
He worries about the purse.
You,
the purse.
The purse. You
the bigger it gets, the bigger the payoff gets, right?
After this, you'll need a purse.
I'm telling you the purse. You're going to be carrying a purse.
Is he allowed to drink before or he has to go straight?
Straight.
No.
I'll tell you why.
Why?
Because I legally did not have you so loaded where you come back and say you were raped.
And didn't have consent.
So you have to be tested to make sure that you're straight.
Oh.
Absolutely.
Straight in every way.
This is a very important thing.
Drug tested.
You have to do this of sound mind. Because you're insane, I think.
Well, that cancels that out right away.
Whatever mind you
could you
have.
Imagine going home to your wife and then her saying okay, and then your kids are okay with it?
Your kids are talking about how to up the ante.
Yeah.
And making you do it longer.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
You know, maybe kids are more politically correct nowadays, but if I was your son's friend, I might tease him about this a little.
He said he can handle it.
I even told my 16-year-old about this.
He can kick anybody's ass.
She's like, oh, my God, how's he going to go to school?
He can kick anybody's ass. Not worried about it.
All right.
Okay.
You're nuts, bro.
So you think it's going to happen? You think we can...
Yeah, no, he's ready to go. I think I can get Giant Stadium for this.
Don't tell him what you're doing.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to be upfront about what I'm doing.
Is Don, like, no way?
No. He's talking to pay-per-view right now.
Oh, he is going to definitely.
Yeah.
Wait, wouldn't you like to be him explaining this to
people? But was Don on board right away, or did he think you were, like, doing
it? I think it was, you know, he was just a little freaked out, and then when he came to his senses, he said, is this something you really want to do? I said, I really do. I really do. I think it's a terrific special. I pay to see Scott receive anal.
Those phone calls are great. Bill, it's Don. Could you take me off speaker?
Is there anybody else in the room?
You're not recording this, are you?
I just figure it's got to be less pain than Casey getting the crap beat out of him for $15,000.
We'll see.
No, I don't think so. What could be more pain?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Do you ever have like a colonoscopy or anything like that? Like
a what, John?
I don't know how to say it right. A colonoscopy? Is that what
you say?
Colonoscopy. Like philosophy.
Colonoscopy?
Do you ever have like a...
No, but I've had a doctor in there.
Yeah, but with what?
He's had a colonoscopy.
Colonoscopy.
With what, his finger?
With his finger.
Yeah.
And that wasn't painful to you?
Dude, this is a guy.
You know, I was brought up like you with rectal thermometers.
No,
all the
dude,
time.
This ain't no rectal thermometer.
No, I know that.
My mother
I know
used
that.
An indoor-outdoor thermometer.
Yeah, she did.
Yeah, she used a meat thermometer.
But I'm saying, so when a guy checks you, isn't that painful?
Have you ever felt this?
No.
I'm talking about when the doctor even examines you, and he's being gentle. This is a dude, for 2 minutes, repeatedly. Although women do take it. Robin took it. She took it. You can take it.
Why not?
Robin was drunk.
Yeah, but you know what? I was excited.
Right.
Yeah, right.
I don't know that he's going to feel.
It's a little more natural.
You picture his big...
And it was still not the most comfortable thing in the world.
People do it all the time. I could be uncomfortable for 2 minutes.
What's your big deal?
Try the rest of your life.
What's the big deal?
I'm uncomfortable just being here.
Oh. And women don't have prostates.
Right.
Man. Oh. What if you... What if you orgasm?
Things can go.
I don't think there's a chance of that happening.
Oh, we'll see.
You never know. You realize things can happen, though, Howard.
Yeah. I mean, you know. Just get on all fours now and see how it feels. I'm just saying, just to get in that position.
Just to see the position, how it feels.
All right, we got to take a break. And let me tell you, it's fabulous news that Scott's ready to go ahead with this.
I'm proud of you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you, Howard, me and John shared a cab yesterday. We were laughing for 10 straight minutes in the back of the cab.
I was laughing. I went to my gym yesterday. I was laughing so hard by myself. Walking around in the hall. People were looking at me.
I told you, I passed Eli in the hall. I just started laughing because, I mean, he's going to be back there working with the guys.
You guys act like it's a big deal.
It is.
You understand the reality of what's going on?
You don't think this is a big deal?
No.
You really don't?
No.
Okay.
Every time you meet somebody for the rest of your life.
Which won't be long, so it doesn't really matter.
This is who you are.
You know what, Howard? You know,
yeah.
Yesterday,
I have no pride left. I don't really give a crap.
Apparently not. Yesterday, our friend Ross, you know, he's down in Florida, so he called me and he goes, hey, how you doing? Anything happen on the show today? I said, listen, I have a lot of time. Basically, Scott's going to take $250,000 to have anal sex with a man. He's like, what? And I'm like, no, I'm not making that up. He goes, yes, you are. And I'm like, no, he's doing it. But imagine, like, if somebody had heard the show, it was shocking.
Oh, yeah.
Should have heard my wife. She's like,
mine too.
What the
hell? Everyone freaked out. All right, so there it is. There's the latest Scott news.
Coming soon to pay-per-view from Howard Stern. Reality television has hit an all-time high. Scott the Engineer, together with his fat, hairy, pimply ass, welcomes a penis for $250,000. Stay tuned for more details.
You got to hand it to Artie. I mean, you were keeping up with him, and sometimes you can't even tell who's singing.
There you go.
Good for you, brother.
That's it.
You're happening. He's happening.
Multi-talented.
You're a happening guy. Hey, everyone, good morning. Yeah. What do you say? And welcome to the show. We have a big, big, big show for you today. Robin, you can see over there a new setup for Stump the Buoy.
Stump the Buoy!
Stacy's coming in. She's going to get naked if she loses, so we've set up a special booth.
So she's got to play naked.
That's right. Crispin Glover's stopping by. The movie Willer getting good reviews in the paper today.
Oh, that's nice.
Well, buddy Greg Fitzsimmons coming by, too.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Looking forward to Willer.
Yes, Willard.
Love your that boyfriend. Franchise.
Willard, your boyfriend, right?
I loved Willard the first time. I'm sure I'll fall in love again.
I know that you always dreamed of being penetrated by a rat.
No, Willard is not a rat. Willard's the guy.
Ben is the rat.
Ben, and who was the best friend rat, though? Who was the first rat?
Cubby.
No, Cubby.
Cubby.
Brian Johnson.
No.
Audie Lang.
Audie was the first one.
Audie Lang.
Audie.
Benjamin Bronk.
No, wasn't it Socrates?
Socrates, that's right. Yeah. You win.
Well, you
don't have to take your clothes off.
No, I told you I love that movie. Ben loved Socrates, and I won't tell you the rest.
How would you charge me to see you naked?
$1 billion.
No, you would not.
Oh, absolutely.
You wouldn't show it to me?
$1 billion, you could see it all.
Oh, come on. I'm not going to pay $1 billion. Get realistic and let's talk price.
There is no realistic. That's the price.
I mean, just in private. You don't have to do it here.
That's the price.
All right.
Because I never want to have to look at you again. I'd be too embarrassed.
What about just the top?
No.
Mm-hmm.
the price of the thing.
How much for one boob poking out of your shirt? Hey, Captain Jakes, what's happening, baby?
Hey, good morning, Howard.
Good morning, Al.
You know, actually, I wanted to make a suggestion. In light of what we learned about Jay Leno with his over-endowment yesterday, why don't we see if we can get him to accommodate Scott the Engineer?
Oh.
See, he won't do it, but we're in the middle of looking for very large men.
Taking applications?
We got some guy we think is going to fit the bill. One of the guys.
All right.
I'll tell you what, Howard. That whole Scott anal thing, that's like everybody's talking about.
I know. Well, I'm putting it together.
It's still not real to me. I look at Scott, and I can't believe that he's really going to do this.
Well, I'm being thwarted all over the place. I got a message from my agent saying that pay-per-view, there's some problem, but I haven't spoken to him yet.
All right.
Tom Chiasano is working behind my back against it.
To pull it off.
Yeah.
Pull it away from
him. Yeah, well, I'm wise to him. I'm wise to what he does behind my back now. I didn't realize he's approaching people in my staff. He yelled at KC the other day. I mean, he just undermines what I do for a living and doesn't consult me on it. And now he can't understand why I think he's such a skunk. But,
he yelled at Casey for coming up with the question.
Yeah. He yells at my staff, and it's just embarrassing to me and ridiculous, and he sends secret messages to people like the Godfather, and it's just I'm fed up with him. But
there's nothing wrong with asking any question, Tom.
I have a secret plan of my own that I'm working on about Tom, which I think is going to finally make me the winner. I'm plotting against him. And a massive coup. I've managed to take away a lot of his power with some of the new guys in the company. I haven't completely stripped him of his powers. I haven't completely emasculated him. Because I used to feel bad for him, but now I don't.
Well, if he's going to do that.
He plots behind my back.
These are adults. People can do what they want to do.
Yeah.
Tom.
Oh, yeah.
You can't stop it.
Yeah.
How does he think the bills get paid anyway?
I don't know. I don't know what he thinks. But it's clearly a religious paranoid I have on my hand. And I've had it with him. But, on the good news, I'm not giving up.
All right.
I'm looking at the Giant Stadium.
There you go.
Up on the big screen.
Up on the big screen, right there.
And the Giants have been giving me anal air for years.
Right. How much have you lost on the Giants?
Exactly. Thousands.
But anyway, Jay Leno. Yeah, that was quite a revelation. Sandra Bernhardt. I thought it was going to be more press on that.
Yeah, you know.
There was press in the Philadelphia papers this morning.
There was. Yeah. In page 6 of the New York Post, they have a little thing about how that Sandra Bernhardt talked about before Jay got married. He had a little affair with her, that he handcuffed her, spanked her, and also he's very, very well endowed.
Yeah.
Which shocked all of us.
Next week, you know?
What?
She'll be on the Tonight Show next week.
She should be.
That's the biggest compliment that you can give anybody.
You know what I did? I got 150 pair of handcuffs. I'm not kidding you. I really did this. And Gary Garver's going to hand them out at the Tonight Show tonight.
Oh, my goodness.
Everyone in the audience is going to hold up the handcuffs.
Oh, that would be great.
Isn't that great?
Oh, that's too funny.
Yeah. So, I did that at least.
The whole audience.
Yeah. I'm supposed to plug the guy who gave us the handcuffs, but I don't have any of that info with me because Gary's late.
No, I'm here. I'll have it in a second.
Oh, okay.
That is a great idea.
I missed Gary this morning because as soon as I sit down to eat, I hear, whoa. In case he'll try and say something, Gary go, I only have time, a little bit of time with Wolf. Hey, Wolf, did you see Survivor?
www.somethingsexy.
Whoa. You're giving the guy a plug. I thought you sent me a note.
That's what it is.
Oh, you couldn't think. I thought you couldn't think of the word.
Yeah, we thought you were just mumbling, you know, something sexy.
www.somethingsexy.
I got to go look at your notes.
You don't know it.
I had it, and then you...
Write it down. Give the guy a plug.
I was good.
All right.
Did you see Survivor last night?
No, I didn't. Wolf.
Survivor was great last night.
Robin, don't say anything. I only have limited time. Wolf.
You know what? Come on, man.
Oh, come on. We're just kidding.
No, you're not.
We had so much fun this morning because Casey was there and he told me whatever he had to tell me. And I go, where's Gary? Wolf. Everyone was laughing.
At my expense?
Yeah.
Is there any other way?
Wolf. Is there any other way?
If I want to have no life, shut up.
Look at Jags. Jags getting in the fray.
I like it.
Sucker punch.
Wolf. All right, Wolf. Wolf, 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 Wolf. All right. Hey, thanks, Jenks. Capitan Jenks. Gary, good to see you. Get the plug for the guy. Give him a plug. All right, listen, we got a huge show. And, okay, somethingsexyplanet.com. There's the guy, somethingsexyplanet.com. Helped us out with the handcuffs for Jay Leno. Gary Garvin's going to go over to the Tonight Show and hand out their handcuffs, and they can hold them up in the audience.
Wave them, yeah.
What are you doing, Gary? You going to get Garver on the phone? You don't have to get him on the phone. Why you get him on the phone?
It might be interesting to see, just go over what he's going to do and stuff.
He's going to hand out the candy.
And he's going to interview people, too, I guess.
All right, so what I got to talk to him for?
It seems pretty clear.
Yeah, get out. You're annoying me for some reason. I can't even tell you why. You just annoy me sometimes.
All right, I'll just shut up.
All right, go, leave. Quickly. Because then we won't have a problem. If you get out of here, I'll forget about you. Sometimes it's hard to look at him. I don't know why. I'm sure it's hard to look at me sometimes.
You do it like a... You do it like a married couple.
You know, sometimes I just know it's enough, Gary. Leave. You know what I mean? Holy cow, I saw something funny yesterday.
What?
Robin Rudzinski and the E! Crew. And I want to find out who put this together, because it's so funny. We got a special coming up on E! Called Howard Stern's Jerk Off. Instead of, you know, Jackass.
Oh, okay.
And it looks just like Jackass. It's a parody of Jackass. But it's every moment we've ever had on the show that is whacked out.
Uh-huh, like, give me an example.
I'll give you an example. Ralph and John throwing sneakers at each other, trying to beat each other up, then quickly into Beetlejuice vomiting, into guy walking in and farting on Don King, and
oh.
And I can't even describe it.
Special little moment.
It's so funny. So friggin' funny.
Yeah, how great was that?
Great. I only saw one. It's going to be 2.5 hours?
2.5 hours. We were thinking about maybe doing a one-hour special to air next Friday. E! Will do lots of promotion. And
they should.
You can talk it out.
It's brilliant. Do it next Friday.
Great.
Got to get
great.
That on the air. You're going to die. It is so funny.
Yeah.
I was sitting, Ralph was over my house. I said, you got to watch this. We ended up sitting there watching it twice.
Wow.
It was so funny.
That's good. It goes by in a minute.
In a minute.
Yeah. Quick clips, huh?
If you're going to do that next Friday, let me know. I'll promote the hell out of it.
I definitely will. And let me tell you also that it was compiled by Mr. Mike Ganji, who shot a lot of the footage.
Wow, he did a good job.
He did a really good
job. You're going to have to compliment
Ganji. I will. I'll compliment the guy. He did it. Whose idea was it? Mike Ganji's?
I think Mike and I came up with it.
Very good.
Ganji.
I knew he couldn't come up with it on his own. I knew he needed you.
Ganji compiled it, and we had a producer, Marty Bike, who came and put together a lot of...
Who did the editing?
It's our regular editor, Joe Mikliszewski.
Joe Mikliszewski did that?
He did.
He's terrific. Joe Mikliszewski.
Yay!
Ganji and Robin Rudzinski.
Wow.
Those are three talented people. Take a bow. Wait till you see this.
He can make a movie.
Maybe he could. Maybe he's got some talent. I don't know. I don't see any evidence, but now I see this show. Maybe he's...
This is the first sign.
Mm.
After how many years?
Right.
He can make a movie if it consists of all quick video cuts.
Yeah. Cecil B. DeFatty actually came through. Well, it's good. I'm telling you. You're going
to
love it.
I can't wait to see it now.
I'm not even hype. Hold it.
Oh, boy.
I'm having trouble. I'm not even hyping this. I'm not even hyping. I'm telling you it's good. It is terrific. And you're going to see it next Friday.
Anytime you can sit down and watch something you just watched.
I never watch our own show.
Yeah, that's a sure sign that it's good.
Hey, Barry, what's up?
Hey, Howard.
Yeah.
Hey, I would never tune in to watch gay sex or pay for it. But what I would do is Scott's wife is so into this and is encouraging them to take anal in Giants Stadium for $250,000. Mm-hmm. I would tune in if, in fact, she would line up next.
Well, that ain't going to happen.
Why not?
Because she's encouraging him to do it, not her.
Yeah. Who's got money for that?
Why won't they?
Dude, it's a miracle he wants to do this.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right.
And believe me, I'm fighting an upward battle here, uphill battle, because everyone's against the special. And I don't understand why, because you know what? I've seen softcore porn on all these channels, pay-per-view channels, and we're not even talking about that. We're not even talking about... Sorry. I'll be right back.
You are listening. More listening.
Well, all hell broke loose.
The Howard Stern Show.
Radio's shock jock, Howard Stern. Howard Stern.
I love Howard Stern. Stern.
I come in here so full of enthusiasm, and then during the commercials, everybody tells me stuff, and I get crazed. Gary was telling me he heard Casey got hauled into a meeting yesterday with Tom, where Tom basically says, I don't like that you made those anal phone calls. I mean, I'm praising Casey for doing some of his best work ever in the last couple of months.
That was a great bit.
I'm proud of him. And Tom pulls my people in without my knowledge and starts screaming at them that they should know better than to think and use their own head. Because Howard is out of control, and if you feed him stuff, he'll use it.
You're a baby, and he's got to have people around you to control you.
And Tom is busy pulling my people and basically telling them not to do what I'm telling them to do.
You're not a professional. You don't know what you're up to.
It's like having two parents who undermine each other. I got Tom pulling my people into a room and telling them they're doing a horrible job. And then I pull them aside and go, keep going. You're doing great. And I mean, it's just ridiculous. We're completely...
You're saying, be free with your thoughts. Tell me everything that comes into your head. And Tom's saying, no, you got to censor yourself.
Yeah, and by the way, I listen to everything before it goes on the air. I'm the one who's responsible.
Right. He should come to you if he has a problem.
Yeah. I mean,
he's beating up on these guys who, you know, he has control of. For no good reason.
Evidently, he yelled and screamed at Casey for a half hour, which does no good. Because I just told Casey, ignore everything he just said. And he's a fool.
Well,
don't listen to him.
Imagine you're Casey and the general manager of the station keeps you in his office for a half hour.
Yeah. And then I have to say bad stuff about Tom to Casey. And I have to tell Casey, listen, the bottom line is this. You don't come up with those ideas. I don't need you. So if Tom's telling you not to think, Tom's a robot, has never thought in his life. Don't pay attention to him. I mean, this is ridiculous. And even Gary said to me, I should have been in the meeting, at least.
Yeah, he should have run it by him. He should never have gone to Casey.
No, he's just a boob.
Because he's trying to use his intimidation tactics to scare Casey out of doing his job.
Oh, then he was busy with secret messages to people yesterday. Don't ask what's going on around here. Tom's a dick. I mean, I got to do it. You know what? I can't just let... I've been laying back the last couple of months saying whatever is being done, I don't care. But I got to care. I got to stop this nonsense. I mean, it's just out of control. When Tom gets a bug up his ass, it's like, oh, my God, he's on the warpath and he's going to win.
He's got a cause.
He's got a cause. He's completely irritated. This is so ridiculous. Then he tells people he's his own man, and then when we ask him about changing something, he goes, Mel said we can't change things.
Right.
So I go, well, I thought you're your own man. Why don't you change something? He invokes Mel's name. He's all over the place. He's just out of his league. I got to get in with this Bob Moore. He's the general manager I want to work with. I've worked with the guy on occasion, and I've told this to my agent, and the company's trying to work something out so I don't have to deal with Tom.
Yeah?
Yeah, well, because even the company knows Tom's. Why do you think Tom just got passed over for that promotion? They see what's going on.
Never get on the air unless you wanted it. You knew what was...
Yeah.
What the question was.
I knew everything.
All that was going to be
said. Yeah, yell at me. Come yell at me. Let's have it out. Let's work out the way I can leave here so I can go do some real radio. Let's get it over with. He's completely intimidated by me, so he goes around intimidating my people, and it's just aggravating me more. And then I'm making phone calls to Mel and the other executives who work here, and I'm bad-mouthing them, and it's making them look bad, and they pass them over for a big promotion. Because I don't want to bad-mouth the guy, but he's out of control. What do you do when the guy who you're working with is out of control? What do you do? What do you do? And, like, he's technically, like, my boss, but not really. I got nothing to do with the guy. He's just another general manager at one of the stations we're on. He just happens to be in the same building with us.
He's pretty funny because he acts as if he can keep something off the air.
Well, yeah, he can. He can keep it in the stupid button, which he did yesterday, evidently. He went crazy on the button. Stuff that all of a sudden, he's just because he's crazed. He doesn't know what to do.
But I'm just saying an idea, like Casey's idea. We have a million ways of getting that on the air without you ever knowing it came from Casey.
Yeah. But what do I got to play games for? Come to me and tell me what bothers you, and I'll tell you what I think. And if you disagree, get rid of me. That's all. If I'm
screaming,
if I'm so out of control that you can't talk to me, and that you can't come to me about stuff, then get rid of me. And why would you want a maniac on the air?
Yeah, that he is a maniac. You shouldn't be working with him. That's where your moral dilemma is.
Just when Tom argues with me, he never wins because I'm smarter than him. I have too much life. But what he does is he has a guy hit a button on me, you know, and it's just, it's ridiculous. What are we doing? I want out. This is dumb. Hey, Tom, how you doing? Tom?
Hello?
Hi, how are you?
Great, how are you?
This is our general manager, Tom Chisano.
Right. Good morning, everybody.
Oh, I wonder why he called in.
Why don't you call my staff in behind my back?
I didn't call anybody in behind anybody's back. Gary was standing there when I said, I got to talk to Casey about that phone call. He said, Casey, you know, talk to Tom. I took Casey and I went into my office, and while Casey was in the office, I decided to make an additional phone call so he could understand a little bit about the problems that I have to deal with, and that was that
conversation. But Casey did nothing wrong. His phone call, it wasn't what you're complaining about. You're complaining about what I did with the phone call, and then it set up the whole Scott pay-per-view.
I was complaining about an edit that I thought should have been in the phone call, and then we... that I took advantage of that opportunity so he could learn more about...
Oh, come on.
Exactly.
He yelled at Casey for a half hour.
You know, I did not yell. I never raised my voice to Casey.
What are you doing with Casey? Casey made a phone call.
Casey made the phone call.
What do you want him to do?
No,
you want him,
no. Let me finish.
You want him to stop thinking?
I'm intimidated by you.
What?
I'm not intimidated by you.
You are intimidated by me.
I'm not intimidated
come
by
talk
you
to
at
me
all.
Before you have a meeting with a staff member where you're going to chew him out.
It's real hard to work with you.
You find it hard to work with me?
No. I said I try real hard to work with you and give you everything you need, but...
No, you don't. No, you don't. If you wanted to give me what I need, you would leave.
Well, you know what? I'll see you later. Goodbye.
Bye. What I need is for you to go.
Well, I was just going to say to Tom, it's just very traumatizing for a guy like Casey who...
Of course.
He feels like he's being pulled in two different directions.
Tom got a hold of Casey twice over this yesterday and started badgering him during the show.
Well, Casey doesn't know what to
Casey
do.
Casey works for me. I tell Casey what to do.
That's right, and if there's an edit that needed to be made in that, you should be the one to do it.
We had a staff meeting yesterday. I praised Casey in front of the entire staff.
And he was just waiting to be called into another office to be yelled at.
Yeah. I said I want to praise Casey for the bit he did where he asked people would they have anal sex for $250,000 because that inspired me to set up the whole Scott pay-per-view, and I want to applaud his thinking. So then 2 seconds later, Tom's dragging him into an office, yelling at him. And I'm like, well, how am I supposed to do this?
And the thing is,
I'm telling a guy, you did a good job. I'm proud of you. And then, of course, Casey next week is up for review. He's got to go ask Tom for a raise. And I'm going to probably take Tom out of that process. I'm probably going to just have to go.
It's certainly not fair to Casey.
It's not. And the guy's doing a good job.
And he comes to me and he's like, Gary, I don't know what to do. Howard tells me to do one thing. Tom tells me not to do it. What do I do? Because Tom's a boss and Howard's a boss.
We have a problem. You know, Tom's wrong. If Tom has a problem with something Casey's doing, he should come to me. And I'll correct Casey. Or I'll correct Casey with Tom. But don't leave me out of the loop. I'm telling the guy to keep going.
And in fact, he should never talk to Casey just for the reason that Casey has to deal with him about his salary. It should always be through you, and he should never even have any personal contact with Casey.
Well, it just puts Casey in a position where he can never win. If he does what you want.
Yeah, and it's Tom manipulating a young kid, and that's Tom takes advantage of the weak. He doesn't really go up against the strong. He would be so far up in this company ladder if he could walk into Mel's office once in a while and say, here's what I'm doing. Mel would respect that. But he can't. He bows to whoever's in power, and, you know, and he picks on an intern, practically. I mean, Casey's, well, what is he? He's a guy.
Glorified intern.
He got right out of college. He's working for me. What is he doing? It's ridiculous. I don't mean to trouble you with business, but it's just crazy around here sometimes. Really hard to put the show together, you know. And Bob Moore and I click, you know, we're on the same wavelength.
Yeah.
And it's not like Bob doesn't come to me and go, I don't think this will work. but he just comes to me, and he makes sense.
Yeah.
He's consistent. Like I said to Tom, well, you have trouble when men speak about anal sex, but not when it's a man and a woman. What are you doing?
But it's also that you're telling Casey, you know, I love you for, you know, your juvenile,
sense of humor,
crazy ideas. And Tom's saying, grow up.
Yeah. He's telling him to grow up. And this job.
Use your job.
Anybody around here grows up, they're out.
But now it's even worse because Casey right now is shell-shocked. Still, now he feels even worse because he didn't want this to get on the air.
I know. He came to you in confidence.
And now it's on the air.
And you told me.
But he doesn't know what to do now, you know?
Yeah.
Well, he feels like he's.
And now Tom will take it out on him, not me.
I'll get a little of it.
Yeah. You guys are in for a good reaming. And you don't deserve it. But this is all about me.
Yeah.
Well, I always, like you said, to me, as soon as you stop being creative, you're useless to me.
Yeah. So what am I supposed to do? As soon as you become Tom, you're useless to me. Because Tom is useless to me. Tom's useless to me. He doesn't do anything to further my career. Yeah, he plans a trip to Vegas, but he makes sure there's plenty of money in it for him. That's, you know, that's all
yeah,
he does.
Yeah, Tom's thinking about him when he does it.
Yeah, he ain't thinking about me, about how to make the show better. That's the way it is. You don't haul in a guy who just did a good job and tell him he sucks. Can't do that
to
me.
Yeah, I'm sure there was no Casey that was great, but.
Yeah, I mean, that was great, but you got. That was a great butt bit. You know, if anything, I took it and did something with it.
Yeah.
I'm the out of control one. You know, not Casey. I hired Casey because he's dopey and
right.
He's a kid and he's got wacky ideas. And I like that. I like that he's out of control. I don't want a show that's in control. I could do that. I could go host the Letterman show if I want to do that. So, Paul.
What?
So, Paul.
You made it outrageous already.
So, Paul, what are we doing over there?
I don't know, Howard.
How about another top 10 list?
How you doing today?
Let's do a top 10 list. All right. Top 10 reasons that we, don't like the Iraqis. Number 10, they're bad people. Number 9, they suck. Number 8, number 7,
Number 6, those crazy burkas.
Number 5. And number 1 reason we don't like the Iraqis, I have shingles.
Yeah, I have shingles, yeah.
Thank you, Paul.
Shingle.
Play some music, Paul, so I can walk to my desk and no one will see my ass. Because I'm a chick. Oh, man. Now we're going to drop some fruit from the building and see what it looks like when it hits the ground. Then I'm going to interview some lame-os.
Are you happy, Tom?
Here's the show. We just dropped a watermelon. Off the building, off the Ed Sullivan Theater. Look at that. Let's drop another watermelon.
Aren't we outrageous?
Yeah, wait, we're going to now I'm going to glue myself to the wall.
Velcro
myself to the wall.
Throw my Velcroed self to the wall.
I'm going to do a Tom-friendly show, a show that Tom can be proud of one day. We'll see how it sounds.
Good morning, everybody.
I suspect it'll sound something like Rick D's. I'm going to let Tom write the show one day. He could think of everything we're going to do. See what it is to put together a 4-hour show. He can come up with some ideas, some bits. I'll just do whatever he wants. I want to see what it sounds like.
Yeah, instead of standing in the way,
yeah.
Actually write the content.
You know what? I've been wrong. I think Tom might have some sort of ability.
Yeah, he seems to know.
So why don't I just wait for him to tell me what to do? I'll sit here.
Yeah, look to him.
No phone call.
So far, so good.
So far, it's pretty easy getting a big audience. Just think of other stuff to talk about.
Yeah, according to Tom, it'll just be exciting if you say you're going to Las Vegas.
Right. When you tell people you're going to Las Vegas, they're really going to be excited. They love when you go to a different city. Yeah? You really think that?
And what do I do when I get there? Oh, just go.
Do what you did last time. Yeah, but we did that already. People want to hear it again. Why don't you just repeat the show? Why don't you give me the day off?
Yeah, just run the tapes.
Well, just think of something new. People say that to me all the time. You're a creative guy. Come up with something new. Oh, okay.
Come up with something different. I don't like that idea.
Yeah.
Well, that's the idea I had.
Yeah, and then when I put an idea on, don't sit there and tell me what's wrong with it. Scott the engineer wants to take anal. He doesn't care if we do it on pay-per-view or if we do it. If we do it in a big stadium. But even he's getting jerked around now.
Yeah.
You know. Everybody's all confused.
Scott's got to be like, what do I have to do to get money?
I mean, he doesn't want to do it, but he needs the money.
I've agreed to take anal.
This is an opportunity for him.
Leave him alone.
And yeah. He is an adult. He signs contracts.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
People make him stick to him. He's totally responsible.
Yeah, that's the problem. And you know in 10 years, I'm Fear Factor will be doing that.
Oh, my goodness.
It's just a matter of time.
Absolutely.
Yeah. We'll have whole shows devoted to this. You'll see.
Here's the stunt.
Here's your stunt. You know, screw Fear Factor. Here's the real stunt. We'll give you $250,000 if you have anal. From the biggest guy we can find. Now that's Fear Factor.
Yay!
You deserve the money. Fear is not a factor for you.
Yeah. Evidently, I'm going to say at the end of the special, evidently fear is not a factor for you.
Oh, thank you.
Evidently nothing's a factor for you.
People tell me they can't even look at Scott in the halls. They don't know what to do.
I can't believe it when I look at him. I don't even know how to talk to him anymore.
I want to go on the record as saying I will still gladly have a beer with Scott after he takes anal.
Me too.
I would not do that. I just right now it's surreal to me when I look at him and think of what he's going to be doing.
I'm sexy.
I know. I've actually visualized it, and I want to tell you, it's not pretty.
Yeah, it's just when I'm drinking the beer, I'm going to be laughing hysterically.
Okay. Hi, Jake.
Hey.
I stopped looking him in the eye.
I know you said that.
It's and
why?
Because I feel ashamed for him. You know, I won't treat him any differently. Like, I'm not I'm the homophobe. It's like, hey, it's your own thing, and I understand. I almost feel bad that he's put in this position to provide for his family. But I'm ashamed for him.
I got to put food on the table somehow.
Hey. I looked at him today. He's wearing a Nike sweatshirt. I'm like, I wonder if Nike was.
Just do it.
The other thing.
go for it.
The other thing that really, really creeped me out was yesterday's conversation when, you know, his son said that he should get extra money for every minute he goes longer.
Yeah. Some might have some anger there.
Let's see, if I go for 2 hours, I could be a billionaire. I could be Bill Gates.
Right, he could stay right there and become a billionaire.
Yeah. I had to make such an uncomfortable phone call yesterday.
Yeah, who did you call?
I called Paul Fishbein.
Yeah.
I said, listen, we've been friends for a long time, so I'm just going to get straight to the point. I said, I need a gay porn star with a really large apparatus who's willing to pull his pants down here. And he's like, what? Hmm. And then I explained it to him, and he was shocked also that Scott was doing
it. Who is the guy Cabby said would be perfect for the job?
Something Steele.
Lexington
Steel. He's this black porn star who Cabby says is like...
Only Cabby would know.
It makes Jay Leno look small.
Yeah, Cabby was in the back throwing names around like, I can get somebody for you.
I said, hey, Cabby, what about you?
Yeah, Cabby would do it, wouldn't he?
Cabby goes, I'm 8 inches. I go, that's hardly enough.
No, it's got to be over a foot.
Yeah.
Well, Paul's explaining to me that most of your well-hung porn stars live on the West Coast, so we have to bring someone
we'll fly him in.
Or we could have Ron Jeremy on Monday.
Ron Jeremy would do it?
Would he do it?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Let's ask him.
Okay.
I mean, I could see a whole show just talking to guys.
He fits the bill because you said you wanted somebody really large who looks like hyperbaric.
Hey, how someone call it with a theory. You think Scott is dying and this is like his last way to make
it?
If he was dying, he wouldn't do it. He wouldn't care.
He's not dying any more than he was the day before. The
problem is he isn't dying.
Yeah. Then here's the other question. Do you think, isn't it hard?
Here's the theory I had. That Scott was a swinger and that he's been doing this all along because it's the only way a guy would do it. But I talked to him. He says, I swear to you, I've never in my life done anything like this.
He's just a little too anxious for someone who's never done it.
Or nonchalant. He just seems to be, like, okay with it.
But he's a guy who doesn't show emotion.
No. But Howard, here's the other question.
Boiling cauldron.
If he's going to do this now, so he's going to get $250,000. His wife already spent it. Would you do it if your wife is going to spend your money?
I don't think she's going to spend it all.
Oh, he says she's already got it all spent.
Don't listen to him.
Well, they're putting some in savings, and he's not going to actually...
No.
We have to plan for my retirement.
We talked about it yesterday. I know where the money's going.
Yeah, so do I.
They're going to fix up the house a little bit, maybe an extension, but not much. Maybe get a car, but most importantly, Scott's son is 2 years away from college.
Yeah.
So he's doing it for his son's college.
Yeah.
son, I need to talk to you.
Oh, if his son, you know, can you imagine the arguments when he says, do you know what I did
right.
for you?
Yeah, you can't argue with that.
The first D that
yeah,
kid gets, that
kid gets like a D average. In the...
Do you know what I did for this college money? How could you disgrace me? How dare you?
I just realized by talking about Tom, he's going to want to call me into a meeting today, and I don't have the time. And I don't want to meet with him. He's going to have to meet with my agent. This is getting out of control.
I have to tell you that the cat and mouse game that's going on between, that's developed between you two is so much fun to watch.
Oh, he just trails me. I, you know, after the show, I can't talk, and he gets me at a disadvantage. He asks me questions, and I just want to go back to my office and rest after the show. I'm not feeling all that well, and he gets a hold of me, and it's like, you know what, dude? Talk for 5 hours straight, and then sit and talk to you. I don't want to do it.
But the part that's interesting is you trying to leave after you meditate and him trying to get you. You know,
yeah,
you're
in the hall.
You run out the door. You yeah. kick, he goes down another way.
Yeah, I mean, it's I have to hide from this guy.
It's like a shell game.
Yeah. I mean, it's like he's hounding me. He's stalking me. Leave me alone. Why me?
And I always feel bad for him. He goes, did Howard leave? And I go, yeah. And he just goes,
let me alone.
Shoulders just hunch.
Is Tom mad at Scott?
He's mad. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, he thinks Scott's doing this to him. He thinks it's about him and Scott. He's completely insane. I'm telling you what I'm dealing with. Scott's got no life. He's easy to pick on.
Well, Scott knows he's irritating Tom, and Scott's going to enjoy this.
No, he's not. He doesn't. He's not
you
comfortable.
Have a wrong opinion.
See, that's the wrong opinion. Scott likes Tom. Believe it or not, I talked to Scott many a time about this. He goes. I don't know. I don't think the guy likes me.
I said this a million times. Tom is the greatest guy in the world. If you didn't have to get a raise from him,
right? Well, or if you didn't have to work with him, he's a great guy. I got nothing personally against Tom. You know, I think he's odd. I mean, any guy who makes a pact with God that he can't masturbate, I mean, that's insanity. You're dealing with somebody insane.
Really, any other pact you could make except that.
Yeah, I mean, why do you make a pact? Why make a pact? What if you feel like doing it?
Just say, look, I won't have any more apples or something.
So what is God going to do for you now that you're not doing that?
So any guy who would make that kind of deal with God, he's making decisions over my people and my show. And I mean, right away he should be fired for that. He's unqualified. He's got too much of a personal agenda wrapped up in all of this. This is a business. I got to have a guy who's, you know, gets it. Because I'm bored.
It's not personal, it's business.
Yeah, you got to get it.
I understand Scott's taking anal. I really don't
God,
know what you're doing.
This is Tom. I know you cured my cancer. And I agree to stop pleasuring myself. But now I come to you, God, with a whole other set of issues. Yes, Tom. One of my employees wants to receive anal for $250,000. Oh, my God, Tom. This is terrible. I know, God. I know that your son, Jesus, would never do something like this. Yes, Tom. Meanwhile, God, after Tom stops praying, he's like, do you believe this schmuck? Tomorrow I'm going to tell him to give up water.
I don't know. Is that another prayer from Tom?
Because the one good thing you can do is touch yourself, and this stupid idiot isn't doing it. He's going to waste that.
I helped him once. Now he won't leave me alone.
I'm going to go tell him he has to give up water. Tom? Yes, Your Holiness. I need you to give up water. Of course, God. Stop masturbating. I've done that already. And I want you to get facial surgery like Bruce Jenner's.
Okay.
It gives him weird things to do. I want you to go harass KC for a half hour tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yes, God.
God, think of some other errands for Tom.
And I want you to hop on one foot.
Okay.
For how long? Forever.
God's like, listen, Tom, I'm still laughing over this. Even the Pope masturbates. I don't care what you hear. I guarantee he does.
Yeah, but does Tom think God sent him here to take care of KC? That's what God is worried about in this stupid world?
Yeah, I want you to take care of KC.
Wouldn't take care of Iraq. Take care of Casey.
Right.
Get him straightened out.
But Scott's ready to do it. I've talked to him several times. I said, is this something you want to do? He goes, yeah, I want to do it.
He's proud.
He seems unfazed by the whole thing.
Yeah. Well, he says, I don't want to do it, but I'll do it for the money.
But, you know, I thought he'd be walking around, you know, sort of like, he's holding his head high.
Yeah. I'm with all that.
He's going to take it like a man.
He wants the $250,000.
It's not life-changing money. You know?
It is for Scott.
What are you talking about? For you, maybe, Mr.
Yeah, Mr. Two Houses.
No, but Artie and I were talking about it. It's not like it's like a million or $2 that you're going to, like, you know, really change your life. He's just going to blow this and...
Why do you say he's going to blow it?
Because he's just going to build an extension on his house and add some furniture. Would you do that? I mean, was that worth it, what he's going to do for it?
If you think about it...
The pleasure he gets, though, from that house?
Yeah.
You could probably build a smoking extension.
That's what it'll be, someplace to smoke.
Somewhere where I can smoke outside of the house but still be encased.
In front of the addition, you should have a plaque of his ass.
Hey, Scott, come on in here. I want to know what you're going to do with the money.
Because you know he can have no say over the money, Howard. That's the thing. I would tell my wife, this money is in my...
Darling, if you let me do this, the money is yours.
If you let me do this...
I'm talking about $250,000.
There he is.
Smoke. When you smell smoke, you know he must be near. Happy engineer.
Now I know why you smoke. So what are you doing with the money? I'm hearing house extension, car... And son's college money.
Well, mostly the college money and...
Furniture.
Maybe furniture. A chair would be nice.
Right.
You're going to need a chair.
Hey. A soft chair.
You're going to need
a hammock.
And a jacuzzi so I can soak.
No, really. What are you going to do with the money? Are you going to build an extension?
Oh, I don't know about that. Maybe, I, you know...
A smoking extension?
Yeah.
No, seriously.
It won't be any smoking.
Right. So
it's going to buy a
lot. It's going away.
But, oh, no, you're going to increase your smoking after.
Have the last couple of days.
Yeah, we're looking for guys. We're talking about this guy, Lexington Steele. I don't know if he goes gay, but if he does, he's the man. From what Cabby says, the guy's a ridiculous monster.
I cannot wait to see this.
Of course.
I wish
John is one person that enjoys other people's
pain.
You know, he just loves pain.
We're all going to enjoy this. See your face
I'm gonna
sweating.
Enjoy too.
Oh.
Do you think you can do this without, like, crying or making a noise?
No.
Or are we going to have to put a bucket under you? Are you going to throw up? Screaming. What are you going to do?
He's going to be screaming. You know?
How do I know?
I don't know if you care, but Lexington Steele is a black guy. Does that make a difference to you?
No.
That'd be funny if it did.
Some people are racist.
You know, Scott, you know, it could ruin your porn career.
Oh, yeah, I didn't think about it in that way.
That's true, because once you go black, evidently your price goes down.
Yeah. I better think about that.
You're going to immediately go to the top of the Klan's hit list. It's a black guy, you're gay.
You got to hear Cabby talking about, like, Lexington Steele. He's like, oh, you got to get a hold of this guy.
Dude.
It's like a big conversation going on. And Scott's standing there with us.
He was all excited, Cabby. He was like, I can get you the best guy.
Over in the green room, Stuttering John's friend sent up all this food. Who is that guy?
His name is Frank from Aiello. It's a Manhattan Italian place.
Oh, the place you took me to.
This is like a pizza place. But it's
so they had some good food over in the green room. We're all sitting there, you know, in the kitchen area.
Uh-huh.
Everyone's, you know, chowing down. Me, Casey, Artie, of course.
Of course, there's food, there's Artie.
Scott was in there. Everyone, Steve the engineer was in there. Everyone was in there. Well, all of a sudden it was like a little party.
Yeah.
This was after the show yesterday, after I avoided Tom in the hall. And then Kevin's like, hey, you know who you got to get? Lexington Steele. This guy's just standing there.
He's really trying to help Scott out.
Yeah, what a guy.
Go, Kevin, what about you? He goes, well, I'm 8 inches.
So he didn't say no.
No, he swore off gay sex.
He says he's swearing off gay sex because he's engaged or something.
He said, look, I experimented in high school. But he was saying it as if all of us were going to go, yeah, we all did that.
Yeah, everybody did that. Yeah,
oh, no big deal.
So we were all, he goes, look, we all experimented, right? And there's like dead silence. Everyone's looking eating. Away, looking at their feet.
It was an unusual conversation.
Anyway, I got the perfect guy, the bank's guy.
So, back to the money. I just like to put most of it in the bank. I mean, you just have it.
What's funny about you is you have this blank expression on your face when we talk about this.
Yeah, I mean, it's like, you know.
What are you going to do, I guess?
Yeah. That was my answer.
That's what's most funny about it.
How do you envision this going down? I mean, like, we're going to pick the guy that night. And then, like, do you think you're going to try and prep yourself, like, before the event? Like to try it? Like, not with a guy, but maybe with, like, something. Some object?
Yes.
You are going to try
you
it.
Are.
Oh, no.
He's got to.
Yes.
Wait, we got to get video of that, too.
No.
It's training.
It's extra money in that.
It's another $100,000 for that.
Yeah.
What are you going to use? Like a apparatus?
Scud. I guess an adult Scud toy might help.
Right.
Well, you're going to probably.
He's going to take it more than once.
Graduate. I mean, he's got to work his
right.
way.
Yeah,
you know,
right.
In a weird way, that's logical because you don't want it to be. I mean, the first time.
It's sort of like spring training.
We should cancel the event the day of.
After Scott's done all his training.
What do you mean they're not going through with it?
What are you talking about? I gotta build up the muscles, don't I?
Or knock them down.
Well, whatever.
I'll start with a birthday candle.
Scott, we can't do it.
But Scott, I got called off.
Are you kidding me?
What are you, crazy?
Have you ever played back there at all?
No.
Nothing.
No, only, you know, when I was a kid. With a rectal thermometer.
Right.
Well, rectal thermometer is nothing.
Yeah. Right.
How's the guy going to get aroused?
It's getting hot in here.
I couldn't even handle a rectal thermometer. I used to freak at that. I mean, do you realize what we're talking about here?
Oh, I realize it, yeah.
No, whatever you work up to, make sure it's big and black.
And let your son apply it. Make him work for college.
See, I have a telephone that's big and black.
Oh, Lexington Steel.
What's going to be your reason?
Honey, where's the cucumber? I'm up to the cucumber.
Do you think his wife will help him train?
Are you going to train by yourself, or are you going to ask your wife to
She's
help
my
you?
My coach.
I'll have to think about that one.
Yeah.
She's my Bobby Knight.
She can be there. That night she go, come on, honey, you know how to do it. We practice.
You can take it.
But it's very different.
I'll
there's cameras and people, and there's a human being attached.
I have feelings.
First thing I'm going to do is go.
And when you get nervous, don't you sort of clinch up?
Oh, I know, I do.
Look how calm he is.
To work out with Richard Simmons.
I got to go buy stock in KY first.
Yeah. You're going to need it.
Need a little of that.
Yeah, I think you're going to need some help.
Hey, Howard, so what are you going to, like, choose for, you know, the guy? Like, you know, what's going to be your criteria?
The biggest guy? A guy who, you know, is obviously into some gay sex. I don't want him to, you know.
We need
to get to perform. We're going to need a backup guy in case the guy is done in 10 seconds because we need 2 minutes. Because Scott's so hot.
Yeah.
Scott might turn the guy on so much.
Yeah, you think the guy's going to have to think of chicks, not to.
See, I knew he's going to have a
he's
lot
gotta
of
go
rules.
2 minutes.
Yeah, it's got to be 2 minutes, Scott.
2 minutes is what we're paying for. We got to have a special here.
Suppose he says.
Did you just see the look on his face?
I told you I'd go up to 5.
No, 2 minutes. Whoa. All we need is 2.
Oh, God.
Scott, you're crazy.
Yes.
Go up to
5. I am crazy.
What do you think it'd be worth? I don't know if I can't say this, but.
I'm just going to get. We're going to line up a whole bunch of guys. I guess porno guys. And maybe some gay listeners.
We can't have performers. We can't have people who are going to choke.
Like gay Ramon and stuff.
But is it cruel for us to pick the biggest guy?
Of course.
Yeah. But of course it is.
That's how you earn the money.
Yeah, I mean, we want to make it difficult.
Well, that's what I'm afraid if you say the audience might just feel bad for Scott and choose, you know, someone that isn't.
There's not going to be anyone there. You're talking about my audience is going to feel bad for Scott,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
If we get some celebrities, like maybe like Andy Dick or somebody.
Yeah.
What?
Gary Ramone leaves me a voicemail every night begging me to do Scott. Just
really?
Me.
Well, he could be one of the 10.
Do you want to practice with him, Scott?
Oh, jeez. I don't think he actually
he'll be
wants
my
to
sparring partner.
No, there's no practice here. There's no live practice.
Well, how are you going to practice? Are you going to include your wife in the practice?
I don't know. I really didn't think about it.
I think you're going to need some help.
I think you should have a guy help you. Because you got to get used to that concept.
No.
Man, you got to build up to that.
No,
what do you mean, no?
No.
You're not going to have a guy help
enough?
You?
No.
You're not going to try it once to see if it works?
No, I said not with a guy, though.
Well, have a guy, no, I mean, have a guy at least use his toy on you. a toy.
Why does it have to be a guy?
So you get used to the sound of like a man behind you.
Grunting.
I think you should leave that for the special. I'd like to see your reaction. Yeah.
I think I'd have to, you know, build up in some way.
Do you know how freaked out John and I are about this whole thing? I sat down, John had his hand up here. We touched hands and we just freaked.
Are you as shocked as I am?
Beyond belief.
I've known Scott for 15 years. I'm shocked.
I'm shocked, too.
It's not like I have to kiss the guy.
Let's not make it personal.
I'll throw in a personal grade if you at least tongue kiss him for like 20 seconds.
How much a G?
Yeah.
It's going to take more than that. What do you mean it ain't happening? It happened for the right price.
Would you throw in a little bit, Howard, of your own just to see him tongue kiss?
I'll give you 5 G's to tongue kiss.
All right, that's 6 grand. No. Come on.
I'm not doing that.
Go all the way.
Would you tongue kiss a guy?
Might as well.
For 250 grand? What the deal with?
Tongue kiss a guy?
For 250 grand? That he's got to think about.
Yeah, I do have to think about that.
See, of course you would.
No, he said he's got to think about it.
Don't think about it. Tell us your price.
Oh, I don't. Come on, Scott.
He would tongue kiss the guy for an extra $50,000. And I know.
Oh, I know that. But do you think that's?
If I throw an extra $50,000.
No, I don't.
No, all right, off the table.
That's a Lexus.
Wait a second. How is this so different?
$50,000 is a Lexus.
How much to give? How much to give the guy oral?
Oh.
Whoa. No. How does this make sense? He wouldn't tongue kiss the guy.
Do you think it's because Scott doesn't have to look at the guy that he's in his mind?
Well, we got to have a monitor right in front of us.
Well, yeah.
You're going to see the guy.
Maybe that.
You're going to get to know the guy.
Yeah, we're going to make sure to see your friend.
How many dates do I get to go out before?
Come on. This is going to be something else.
So Pace and I were having a discussion, Howard. If you're in prison and you had no choice, and it was either get taken from behind or you had to give the guy oral pleasure. That was your choice. You had no choice. What would you do?
I'd be killed.
But I said the same.
I'd rather be killed.
But you had no
choice. But you're going to live, so what are you going to do?
I don't want to live. Not
you
with that choice.
You are going to live. You might kill yourself afterwards.
I can't. All right.
What are you going to do?
You know, I'm not doing anything. I'm laying there.
Yeah,
there's no right answer.
I'd say kill me.
I'd fall on the ground.
I'd hit the guy with a rake.
Yeah.
I'd fight till the death.
But fall on the ground.
I don't get this.
They're holding you down.
Then I got no choice.
Something, so you're going to take it, right? Like Scott.
No, I'm not. No.
One of those things is coming. One of those things is coming to you. You have no choice, so they're either going to pick it or you're going to choose it.
I just can't answer this question.
No, I can't either.
I don't know how Scott answered it, but I can't.
A penis is coming at you. You have to turn one way.
Which way are you turning?
Howard, I'm not a rich guy. I would never do this for $2 million. This is crazy.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know.
Do it. He made his choice.
He's not you, John.
I think John does have a price.
See, but you've gotten paydays of $100,000.
Yeah, right.
He had a big payday for his push-ups.
$10,000. We're talking about this is $250,000. Andy High, you're on the air.
Hey, what's up, Howard? I got to ask you a question. Are you going to have, like, doctors on staff or something?
Yes, we will have a doctor on staff.
He's probably going to need stitches right after that, something like that.
What happens if Scott passes out in the middle?
No money.
No, the guy
keeps going. The guy has to keep going.
Well, wait. One other question.
What the hell?
Are you going to have a good time there? Because he's going to pull that clap where it was a minute and a half. He's going to stand up and say, it's over. No deal, you know what I mean?
No, there's going to be judges and everything. This is very professional.
There'll be an official clock and
official
timer.
A question.
Okay, that's right. Harvey Fierstein to sit right there and tell
us. Harvey Fierstein's our judge.
Hey, Howard, suppose after the first 10 seconds he goes, no, that's it.
He doesn't lose the money.
He loses the money. He knows what he has to do.
I believe that Scott's...
What
do you got?
Call your goddamn car over, you stupid jerk!
Who is that? Andy.
Whoa, yeah, Howard.
What happened?
I'm driving a truck here.
What'd the guy do?
He cut me off.
What are you going to do about it?
If I get up to late, I'm going to punch him in the face.
Well, nice. No.
Meanwhile, he's driving his truck on the cell phone.
I know, right?
Calm yourself.
I'm sorry, Howard. I shouldn't have freaked out like that.
Hang on, Howard. I got to finish my beer.
Oh, my God. God forbid you cut off a truck driver. You're dead. You're dead meat.
Don't follow you.
Yeah, they kill you.
It's a tough job, Howard. Tough
I know
job.
It is. I know. All right, brother. Listen, you better go take some more speed.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Yeah,
those guys are all jacked up. Those truck drivers, stay away. Yeah.
That was hilarious.
Meth out. Crystal meth.
That was hilarious. Wow! What are you doing, you stupid dark? I'll kill you.
I told you not to use the goddamn tape.
Scott,
did I say you don't use the tape? Get out of my way!
I told you.
Get out of my way! I would have never let you come if I knew you were going to use the tape. No f***ing way, Ganji. Now stay out of my face.
Scott, I told
you. Get out of my face!
You have such anger.
Can't you cut me off?
Get the camera out of here.
Scott, you...
Out of here!
Have you ever been that angry?
I think no.
I've never been that angry.
That was a creatine-induced
I don't know.
Rage.
I took out a piece of my wall when Scott Einziger took my show, but other than that...
Hey, I saw that show. What? Oh, so bad. It was on last night?
Yeah, it's horrible.
Oof.
Don't get me started, dude.
That's all right.
I'll give you an
hand.
I'll hurt you.
You'll
yeah, you'll get it for free.
Yeah.
What?
I was going to tell you the story that cured me from my road rage, because I used to get involved in this crap all the time,
because
I drive a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So I was driving home one day, and this guy started tailgating me, you know, really close, and he's putting on his brights and everything. So I let him get in front of me, and then I start tailgating him, putting on my brights and everything. We were on the highway. We must be doing about 80 miles an hour. The guy slams on his brakes.
Ooh.
So I had to slam on my brakes. The back of my car's fishtailing all over the highway. I go, this guy's going to let me smash into him just to be right.
Yeah, you're crazy.
So I just, after that, I just stopped.
Yeah. I mean, you just got to let
it
go.
I've almost gotten out a couple times, and then I realize I got kids
and
stuff.
That's crazy.
I know.
Dominic.
You know, all the wild things that have happened over the 20 years, this is the only thing that travels with you all day.
Yes.
You think about it. People talk to you about it, and they say to you, is he going to do it? Now, I want to know is when Scott walks around and people talk to him, what does he say?
Yeah, I'm wondering if his friends have talked to him about this. The bowling league has said anything.
Let me tell you something. I had to have a heart-to-heart with Scott about it yesterday. And without going into the details of the conversation, it was uncomfortable even just talk. Because I said, Scott, let's talk off the air here. Are you ready to go do this thing? Because I don't want to waste time trying to get this together. And he goes... I'm prepared.
That was a long conversation.
That's like asking somebody to go on a suicide mission.
I mean, it was well, it's like being the Al Qaeda network and you're planning the World Trade Center.
You were gone for like 20 minutes.
Yeah. Yeah, we were in there for some time. Yeah.
Was it like a heart to heart?
It was uncomfortable.
Oh, my goodness. And you had to explain that you know what you're letting yourself in for.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
This is what we need to do.
Yeah, it was uncomfortable. And but he had to keep, like, he was like, you know, it's not something I want to do, but I have to do it. And I know. I go, do you want to do this? Well, look, I don't want to do it. I go, no, I mean, I know you I wish there was another. He was trying to come up with some other way he can make $250. I go, Scott, I don't have another way.
You
know,
Scott,
I could.
Are you feeling all right physically?
Yes, I feel fine.
Because you made a comment yesterday like, well, I have to do this because this is how I can leave something. And I wonder what you meant.
Well, he smokes. He's, how much longer has he got to live? That's what I meant. It's a miracle.
Unfortunately, now Scott's going to live.
I'm afraid for the guy who gives him his treat because you can't catch the lung cancer that way, can you?
Well, one last thought. You know, you're going to actually pick the guy, Howard, that does it.
America chooses. America will pick.
We'll just have the finalists.
How about all of them be transsexuals, you know, with the dressed as women, and then they show their, you know what, and then you pick.
What is your thing? You always want men in women's clothing.
That's Dominic's thing.
What?
He loves when men are dressed up as women.
Stop it.
He does.
He's always talking about getting with men.
Oh, because
women.
What if
one of the men wears pretty shoes and stockings, fishnets, and...
Donald Trump and the Merry Widow.
All right, thank you, Dominic.
Hey, Howard, is your bet that Scott's going to go the distance?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
He
might pass
Scott
out.
I think he's out in like 45 seconds.
You do? You think he'll tap out?
I think he just won't be able to hit
the live action on that. At 45 seconds. You got to go.
I think he might tap out.
I don't think
he's realizing what's going to go on.
I don't think he does. Because think of the guys we're going to pay.
Oh, man.
Oh, stop it, John.
We're talking about Lexington Steel we're going to try and get.
Yeah.
I mean, have you ever seen a picture of him? Hey, look him up on the internet, guys. Lexington Steel.
See who Scott's going
to
get?
We should be able to get a picture.
John, I'll go 500 with you that Scott does it.
The whole 2 minutes?
The whole 2 minutes.
I'll go 100 with you.
All right, 100. I'm betting on Scott.
All right, I say he at least...
I lose.
Wait, but suppose he stops the first minute, then goes back.
Oh, he took Scott. He's tapping out.
I'm saying that he's at least going to have to stop.
If Scott gets the money, I get the money. That's
whatever the judges
say.
You don't want to bet. See, I'm saying that he's at least going to have to stop and turn away.
No, if I'm saying he gets the money.
I just do it.
All right.
I didn't do all the paying just to make sure, right. make sure he loses.
Artie's saying right, Scott's going to go the full 2 minutes.
All right. $100.
Okay. I'm trying to support the guy. He's got a tough day.
I'll bet on Scott.
Yeah. You think he's going to go? Wait, take a look at Lexington Steel. Anybody got a picture of him yet? What did they say? 13 inches? Let me find something that's 13
inches.
I didn't
talk to Candy. I don't know.
Do we have a ruler out there?
I'll tell you what's 13 inches. Hold on a second.
Oh, please, put that back. That's not 13 inches.
No, Howard, from my fingertip to my elbow is about 13 inches.
Oh, my God.
That's what I'm saying.
They're Lexington. About to bring up Lexington
Steel. Oh, there's Lexington
Steel. Oh, boy.
What? Oh, here's a ruler. All right.
Oh, my.
All right. God. There's Lexington Steel. Look at this guy.
All I have to say is, ow!
All right, you ow! See this ruler?
Oh, yeah. My.
This is 12 inches.
He's one more than
so,
that.
So, hold on. Wait a second. Let me measure this out for you to give you an idea.
Well, another inch. I don't think another inch is going to matter.
You see my megaphone?
Well, that's not going
anywhere. Wait. You see my megaphone?
Yeah.
That's 9.5. Right there.
Yeah, but.
Whatever. That's 9.5.
Okay.
All right, hold on. Wait. Let me show you something. Yeah, I'll give you another comparison. All right. See this tissue box?
Yes.
Hold on. That's 10. All right? Let's see if Steel's 13.
Ooh.
All right.
It's going to what?
It's going to be a long night.
All right,
a long
something.
2 minutes.
Robin, let me see if I can find something. Here, wait. Okay. All right, you see this loose leaf binder? See it?
Yeah.
That's only 11.5.
Yeah. And it's blue.
Yeah, it's not black, it's blue.
Anybody got any paper towels? Because I'd like to know how long a roll of paper towels is.
Paper towels? All right, you see this? What is this?
Oh, wait a minute.
Give me something else.
Oh, my God.
All right, you see this bottle?
Wait a minute.
See this bottle? Okay. This here is 11 inches. The top included. Okay? Let me see that. All right, see this microphone?
It looks about 10.
All right, here. This microphone, this is 11.5.
Yeah, practice with that.
Okay. And there's a picture of Lexington Steel.
Oh, my goodness.
Holy.
All right, you see this jar, Robin? This vase? I can't even find anything. This is only 9 inches. This doesn't even come into the picture. All right. You see this bottle of... All right, you see this award I received?
Oh, yeah, there you go.
Outstanding radio personality.
Oh, my.
This is 11.5 inches.
Oh. Is everything 11.5?
There's nothing in the room is big.
Just understand that.
Oh, no.
All right, you see this Poland Spring bottle?
This is a
liter and a half.
Yeah.
This is 13. This is almost 13 inches.
Oh. Wow.
There's your practice.
So there's what we're talking about. Let Scott hold that.
Oh, I have something Scott can practice with.
What is that?
The guy's from Queer as Folk left me this.
Oh,
wait a minute.
That's a doorstop compared to what Scott needs.
But that, look at that. That could get him started.
Yeah.
Opening the area.
You know what? I'll bring some guys in next week so you can take a look.
Thank you.
All right.
I mean, you can measure the circumference of that and see how Scott can do.
All right. You know what, Robin? We got to take a break. Scott, good luck in your mission. I'm still trying to put it together. You know that.
I know.
I've talked to you about it. And we'll take a break. We'll be back right after these words. What's happening, everybody?
Hey now.
Hey now.
Hey now. Hey now. Hey now.
What's happening, everybody? Good morning.
Hey now.
What's happening? No answer?
Yay! Not much.
No. I was just talking to Scott, the engineer, who came running into me. He goes,
it can't happen. It can't happen. I have to can't do it.
Did he finally come to his senses?
There's too much going on with it. It's getting out of control.
My life's getting turned upside down.
Yeah. My life's getting turned upside down.
Well, who didn't know that was going to happen?
Scott.
Yeah, I mean, didn't you expect this to happen like a week ago?
I can't have anal sex on camera because it's crazy.
People will see you.
Yeah, right. What happened specifically? You're not telling me.
I mean, just, you know. When
I imagine your son is getting hammered at school.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
I mean, you know.
So I was surprised your son was into it.
I just want to.
He must be a chip off the old block.
It grew to enormous proportions.
Did you get calls from relatives by any chance?
I got calls from everybody.
Like who?
I'm just friends, people, you know, like.
When you decide to become a homo, I guess it's a big announcement.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah, that's a big announcement.
Yeah, people do call with you.
In my family, that would be a big announcement.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Artie's taking anal.
In Artie's family, the answer would be don't ever come here again.
We're punching you in the face.
Like when did you make the decision? What was the last straw?
When I heard my mother turn over in a grave.
No, really, what happened?
No, I mean, you know.
Without joking, I mean, tell me the reality, what happened?
It wasn't one specific thing.
No.
It was just a combination of, like, you know, a week of just getting it from everybody.
But your parents aren't alive anymore,
no,
correct?
No, no, no.
So did you get calls from, say, like, your sister and your brother? You don't have a brother.
My sister, you know, she called.
I didn't even know you had a sister.
Yeah, she's got a sister.
Really?
Yeah.
She has a beard, too.
What did your sister say to you?
She was like, are you out of your mind? You know.
Did you say yes?
Yes, absolutely. I must.
What do you do when your sister calls you and says, are you out of your mind? Did you say at first, like, hey, you know, this is my decision?
I said, listen, it's a lot of money. We could use it. And, but she was supportive. Anyway.
Supportive.
Like, you know.
She'll still love
me. Yeah, she'll still love me, even though I'm.
If you're going to get her on all fours, I'll still love her.
What was weird is he was going to waste the money on furniture.
Right.
I know.
That was really stupid.
That money's too important to waste
on furniture. No, I wasn't going to waste it on furniture.
Yeah, anytime you go and do something like this for the money, it should be used for only very important things.
Well, Scott was like, we're going to use it for my son's college. And, you know, my feeling is, let your son get a job
before
you
do that.
He has a job.
Yeah, well, let him get two jobs.
Let him get on all fours if you can do it.
Yeah. If he wants to go to college so bad, let him take it.
There was a big discussion. I had dinner Saturday night. The big discussion was that Scott was going to use the money for his son's college fund.
Mm.
And just how weird that was. That Scott was going to get on all fours.
You see what I mean, everybody? I mean, it was the topic of conversation everywhere.
Yeah.
For me,
everywhere.
For me, so.
I mean, I didn't think, you know what? I didn't think.
Don't you like being the center of attention every once in a while?
I know it was a big deal, but it just, I mean, giant stadium, the whole thing.
It was a topic of conversation for me everywhere this weekend, and I wasn't doing it.
Right.
Like, the cameraman on Hollywood Square said, please tell Scott not to do it.
You know what's weird? I think when we decided to get Lexington Steel.
Yeah, maybe.
That freaked you out.
That shook him into reality.
I told you, it wasn't one thing. It was just everything piling on.
Your wife was still behind it, right? I mean, she was still into it.
No, it was getting.
She wavered?
It was getting to be too much.
She didn't want it either?
Your wife wavered on this one?
Yeah, I mean, you know.
She didn't want her husband having anal sex on television?
Not publicly.
I really wish I could get to the bottom of what happened.
She'll never tell a good story.
I'm telling you the whole thing.
You're not telling me.
You're not telling us anything.
My son came home and he said his whole school knows.
Right. That's funny.
Yeah. And I said, you know what? It's not worth it. It's not worth it to put, because it's going to continue going on.
But didn't I tell you that the first day that your son was going to be ridiculed at school, that he'd have to be homeschooled?
Yeah, I think several people mentioned it.
Mm. But it exploded.
And we said, do you know your son has to go back to school?
What's he going to do when he has to get up and explain what dad does for a living?
Well, and the truth is that really, it's
showing. I don't do it for a living.
You're not doing it because you don't want to. You know what I mean? In other words, it's still out there that you'd like to do it.
Yeah, you're still willing to accept it. No matter what money is being paid, you're still...
You would do it.
You're doing it.
See, Rob Rosinski and I had this conversation. We're like, you know...
You're still going to get all the ridicule now, no money.
That's exactly the conversation we had. It's out. So whether he does it or not, the damage is sort of done.
Yeah, I mean, like, why... Well, now you might as well do it.
You're gone. Right. This
I don't know if I do it.
Everybody knows you're a big fag.
No, no, I don't think so.
Yeah.
You know who I feel bad for is Lexington Steel.
Yeah.
This was a great opportunity for him.
I never heard of the guy before this.
Yeah, to get some exposure.
I was going to bring in all these guys, these porno stars. It was going
to
be great. Right.
Exactly. That's why I wanted to stop it before you...
Now you're gay with no money.
Crazy. I'm not gay.
You're broken gay?
No, I'm...
Joe, you're on the air.
Hey, Howard, what's up?
What's up?
I just want to say that I'm thankful that this story is finally getting put behind us.
Yeah.
I mean, it is so... Oh, man.
Yeah.
I'm so tired of hearing about it. It just disgusts me.
Jay, you're on the air.
Hey, Howard, like you were saying, he's got to go along with it at this point, because right now we know he's a homo. At least make the money.
Right.
And, Cal, can I ask him one question?
Yeah.
Hey, Scott, homo says what?
What?
There you exactly. go. It worked. Well... I don't know. I still think there's more to this story.
Yeah, I think there was some piling on, and I want to know who sat him down and actually talked some sense into him.
Yeah, who got a hold of you?
No, nobody. I mean, it was, I told you. It wasn't any specific, except, yeah. I mean, my son's school was like the topper. But
what was going on there? I mean, did your son,
were they putting it on the PA system?
Did your son have to come home and say to you, listen, Dad, like, this thing's very big at school?
Or
yeah,
did he just
I mean,
come
he just
depressed?
Said the whole school knows. I mean, you know, so
how did it affect him? I mean, like, would people just come up to him and say your dad's a homo?
Or did they just burst out laughing when?
Well, yeah,
I don't know exactly.
I couldn't believe how casual you were about that part, because I was saying to myself, our kids way more sensitive nowadays than when I was young, because that would have been the first thing I'd be worried about.
Scott, you'll never get a good story out of Scott.
Yeah, he won't tell you exactly
I'm
what
telling you what's going on.
You're the worst storyteller. Now I realize why I'm successful on radio.
Yeah, no,
guys
you
like
haven't right. told I'm us not... one thing, Scott. We've tried to drag out of you who said what.
I told you.
In defense of Scott, he has no idea what's interesting about his life.
Yeah, but all you'd have to say is, my sister said this. This is what
he's not capable.
This one called me, that one called me. No, he's everybody.
He can't tell a story. He's not.
It blew up.
He's the world's most boring guy.
So I get, you know, I get.
You could be. This could be a great segment if you would just tell us what.
So
happened.
I got a call from somebody in my bowling league. What are you doing? Okay.
Right.
You're crazy. You're out of your mind.
Right. Who's this guy? Just some suburban dude.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just a guy that.
Or the head of the bowling league.
No, he's not the head of the bowling.
I love that everyone chimed
well,
in.
Actually, they help. No, forget it.
They don't call him when the bowling has been canceled.
I was going to say joke, but forget it.
All right, go ahead. Yeah. So he calls you.
He calls me.
And how does he approach you? Does he go like?
What are you doing, man? What are you, out of your mind?
Really?
Yeah.
Does he start off that way, or he says, hey, Scott?
He goes, hey, Scott, what are you doing? I mean, that was exactly the conversation.
You screw him.
He doesn't call him when bowling's been canceled.
Yeah.
He calls him for this.
So then who else calls you? All right, I'm gonna get you off the hook, because...
Yeah, I mean, it's pulling teeth.
It's pulling teeth with you. You tell the worst stories.
I know.
You got information, you won't give it up.
No. What information?
Believe me, it must have been a great story. I wish it happened to me so I could tell it.
Last weekend was the most exciting weekend of Scott's life.
Right.
His phone never stopped ringing.
Hello?
Hello? We'll never know.
Yes, I'm going to put my ass on display. Yes. And you want a vegetarian? Which kind of objection? Okay, duly noted.
All right, so the bottom line is Scott's not doing it. That's what I wanted you to know. Right.
But
all
I wonder if he fought with these people, even tried to defend himself for a while. When did he cave?
No, I just said, you know, it's a lot of money. That's it. I would just say it's a lot of money. And
I think your son is the one who put the nail in the coffin.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Was your wife still behind it, or was she getting grief?
No, she was... I mean, obviously, when my son came home with that, she was like, okay, I think, you know, we've had enough. That was it. So, let's...
She called it. I knew.
Yeah, she called it off. Yeah.
Look, honey.
I know.
No.
Yes.
It's not a bad thing. Your wife had enough.
Family decision. We all did. It was a family decision.
But
so
she said,
I am not doing this.
Yes.
First of all, I'm
it
not.
It was a family decision whether Scott should take
it's
it
a lot of
from behind from a man.
Right. The money was very appealing,
right.
But in the end, so to speak, it's not worth it.
All right.
Look,
there
honey,
it is.
Sure, I could use the money, but I'll do other stuff.
Because you're willing to do it. It's just.
No. I'll do other stuff.
I mean, you were willing to do it. It's,
Scott, it takes, you know, there's a leap there to say, I'm willing to do this no matter what the money is.
Right.
Yeah. You're seriously demented.
Yes.
Fred and I looked at each other and said, something broken, Scott.
Yeah, she's a broken man because he's like blank. Even when I was talking to him about it, there's this blank expression.
Hey, you do what you have to do for the money.
You gotta do what you gotta do to put food on the table.
This is blank. Like nobody home in there.
Right.
It's like he was broken years ago.
Oh, yeah, that's...
Definitely.
I mean, just a broken guy. I mean, the kid who used to play drums in a band and had his future ahead of him.
What happened?
Yeah, I mean, there he is, Uncle Fester.
Look, honey, it would have been a nice addition, but...
Well, I guess we have to go back to living on what I earn at the radio station.
We have to pull our dreams aside.
Does your wife work?
No.
Maybe she ought to get a job. Make a little extra cash, seeing as how you have to take anal for money. She doesn't want to work?
No, I mean, you know.
What does she do all day? Stay home and watch TV?
I take care of Scott.
And she's got, you know, the stuff that goes on in the house, I guess, normal stuff.
Like what? I mean, what could keep her that busy? Maybe she ought to get a job.
Nah,
why don't you talk to her about it?
Okay, I'll talk to her.
Maybe give her something to do.
Yeah.
Take some of the load off of you so you're not...
Yeah, so you're not taking anal.
Over.
So you're not doing guys.
You're not taking anal.
Listen, Macy's is looking for somebody. Please.
Look, honey, we might need a second income. I'm considering taking anal.
I mean... Maybe it's time your wife chipped in a little.
Quick Check is looking for a night manager.
Yeah, I mean, what's wrong with that? You know?
I mean, look at the kind of pressure you're under. Look at what you're willing to do.
Yeah, I mean, you're taking the responsibility of provider way too seriously.
Well, yeah, I guess.
Hey, Keith, you're on the air.
Hey, Tom's the one. Tom gave him money not to do it. That's the only way he can get to you.
Did Tom get to you?
Tom paid him off and told him to keep
Did you have a conversation with Tom? No, what?
No, I haven't.
Oh. All right. No, he
I
says...
think he's lying.
Make no, I haven't.
Pull the Bible.
No, because Scott would tell me that.
No, I really haven't.
All right. You guys have a good morning.
Right. Hey, Mike, you're on the air.
Howard.
Yeah.
How about letting Gary the retard go for it? Since he said he would do it.
I don't think it's the same.
It's not legal.
He's a retard.
Oh, man, that'll be cool, man. You know, you don't know people are talking about that.
Yeah, I never done it with a guy.
I'll try it.
I guess.
I've never done it with the guy.
I like a girl.
I do it with a girl. Nobody's going to pay for that.
Yeah. That's going to cost you $250,000.
I'm not even sure he understands the concept.
Right.
What is it, Ronnie?
I think you should pay a price for this.
Why?
Because he scammed everybody.
How did he scam everyone?
Because he wound everybody up.
Yeah.
For his big deal thing.
Yeah.
And, you know.
And now we have nothing to look forward to.
Yeah.
I mean, everybody in the world was talking about this.
All right,
man.
Scott, give Ronnie oral.
Okay. You should have some kind of penalty for this crap.
Did you laugh?
Did I laugh?
Yeah, was it funny?
No, I thought you were stupid.
Ronnie's like his son's friends at school.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's exactly who his son ran into.
This is horrible.
What the hell's wrong with you?
Go drive your car, will you?
What's wrong with you?
What's your point, John?
I was so looking forward to this. And you know what? The thing I don't get about Scott is that we told him the day of that this was all going to happen. People were going to tell him. He said, don't worry, I'm going to stand my ground. Immediately.
It's like you working out for the Dragons or whatever. You think you're going to be a football player.
I was still trying.
They told you that day.
Yeah, but still try out, though. I'm not like you, Scott.
But they told you that day.
Scott, then you... it's like me telling her that I'm going to fight Cabby, and then suddenly, like 2 weeks into it, say no.
Yeah, but at least she's not gay, man. he might get his ass kicked by the football players, but at least he's not gay.
I'm not gay. I'm not gay.
Excuse me?
I'm not gay.
Sure you are.
What the hell's up with that?
Scott, you knew this was going to happen. How do you? I mean, you knew that people would call and tell you.
What's wrong with you, man?
You're supposed to be strong.
Give me some headgear. I'm getting pounded.
No, seriously, you knew it was going to happen. People were going to say to you, "Don't do it," and you said that you'd still do it. You don't care what people say. What happened tonight?
You know, you got a point. You're convincing me, the two of you guys.
Yeah, really.
It's like, you know what? Like,
scammed everybody. Payback.
Yeah.
Scammed you.
And I even had a private conversation with Scott where we sat down and we looked each other in the eye, even though it was painful.
Yeah.
Right.
I've never actually looked him in the eye before. And I said, are you serious? Because I'm, excuse me, I'm having a whole... Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Walk around the street.
Yeah, that's for being stupid and gay.
I said to him from the beginning, you know... Are you really into this? I mean, a private conversation off the air. And he was like, yep. I'm telling you, I'm ready
even
to go.
As late as Friday, he was a go.
And I'm busy scrambling around with these pay-per-view guys.
Right, having conversations, having these embarrassing conversations.
Got my agent all over.
Embarrassed boss, man. What'd you do?
And now it's not going to happen.
Hey, how, did you know that?
Look at me, he's laughing.
Did you know that Ronnie will not hang out with Scott now? They were friends, but now he won't hang out with him anymore.
Why?
Because he was going to do this.
Really?
Ronnie was incensed the first day that Scott said he would do it. Ronnie was down in the garage just screaming at whoever he could find.
Yeah, he told me. He thought Scott was crazy.
Yeah.
I don't want any part of your gay per-view special.
I never realized he was that money hungry, man.
Yeah, Ronnie was screaming about that Scott's money hungry, the wife's money hungry. This is crazy. This is crazy.
Yeah,
something
he
like
was
that,
just
man.
Screaming about everybody in the whole
Ronnie
thing.
Was upset. I had to calm Ronnie down.
He lost a friend.
Oh, the guy's driving. It's where he's been driving a wall.
What's wrong with you, man?
Yeah, see, for me, I'm screwed up. I like you, Scott, but for me, the thing that will always stick with me is that without outside intervention, you would have done it. And that just seems odd to me.
No. Why would you even say you were going to do something like that, man?
No, the thing that stuck with me is that for a whole week he said he would do it. A whole week he had us all looking forward to it. I couldn't wait for this.
Yeah, but I mean, why would he say something like that? What's wrong with him?
He's not kidding.
I don't get it.
I know he's not kidding.
I don't get it.
So are you mad that he canceled or are you mad
I
that
think
he
a lot of people are confused about Scott.
I get it. I'm confused too.
Ronnie, will you ever have dinner with Scott?
No, his wife won't even talk. But I mean, wait a minute.
Wait, she talked to you already.
Yeah, she talked to me.
Come on.
She bought me a Christmas gift now.
Yeah,
so I don't get what's going on. I mean,
but would you go out with him socially?
She won't go out with us. Are you kidding me? We scammed her. Look at what he just did, man.
Mike, you're on the air.
Hey, Ronnie.
Yo.
Ronnie, will you sleep in the same room with Scott at that racing school you
No,
go to
we're not going anymore.
Or you got to sleep with one eye open.
No, we can't sleep in the same room, man. I can't even go anywhere with him now.
I know.
You can't hang out with him?
I mean, how could you go to a racetrack with this guy? He'd kill us. Hey, Ronnie, what are you doing with that fan?
You're not into
Ronnie, this. You on a date?
They're definitely not into this kind of stuff.
Are you more mad, Ronnie, that he canceled or more mad that he's going to do it?
It's both, man. I mean, first of all, don't say you're going to do it and then, you know, I mean, what's up?
It's already ruined for Ronnie when he was going to do it.
What are you looking now at me like that for? What's wrong with you, right?
You know what, Scott? You didn't even have to do it. Now we just think you're almost.
All right, fine.
He got no money and everyone thinks he's a homo.
Hey, he's a poor homo.
He's such
man.
A loser.
That's the worst part of the whole thing.
Yeah.
I tell you what, I walked in this morning and before Scott even told me anything, he started looking at me and I was getting creeped out.
Nah, you knew. You probably knew the minute you looked at his face this morning.
No.
I think he wanted you.
I got weirded out. Like, it's weird to look at Scott now because, you know, he's gay.
So how far along was the planning for it, Aaron?
Well, I'll tell you what. My agent had already put in all the calls to DirecTV and pay-per-view. He was also checking into venue. You know, venues.
So are you a little angry at Scott for canceling?
Of course. Okay. Well, I care because I got to now cancel everything I've got, you know.
Those wheels from turning.
It was weird.
But that's what I mean.
I kind of put myself on the line because pay-per-view calls me regularly asking me what I want to do. And then I kind of called them, and, you know, now I can't deliver the goods.
Now you're going to seem in business as crazy as
Scott. Well, I wish I had never called them.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, what is wrong with this guy? We ask him for a project, then he starts calling us and telling us he has something, and now he's saying no.
Come here, Ronnie. What's the matter? Ronnie.
It's disgusted.
He just walked out.
He's pissed. He was dying to come in.
No, we got somebody here. I got to go outside.
All right, Scott.
But it is weird when you have to pull something off the table that quickly. In business, it makes you look a little shifty and crazy. Yeah.
Well, people thought this whole thing was crazy anyway.
Well, that's
you think it was, yeah, the initial call kind of makes you look crazy.
I'll tell you the truth.
You're just crazy, period.
I'll tell you the truth. It wasn't going well with the pay-per-view people.
Really?
No.
They weren't
too choked up about it.
Well, they weren't choked.
They also said, well, one of the things they said was, we can't promote it. And I was like, that's okay. But there was like a big deal to them. We can't announce that this is coming up on our schedule.
You shouldn't announce a lot of the things you put on.
Yeah, a lot of the crap you guys put on you shouldn't announce. Like, half the fights.
It's back to watch it already race Bianca.
Yeah, guess so.
Yeah, I guess we'll have to book Giant Stadium for that.
It is Bianca's birthday today.
Wow.
St. Patty's Day. 1 year old, my dog. My dog is a year old. Hey, that's a lot more wholesome than listening to his anal.
Exactly.
So, I don't know what's more gay.
Yeah. Well, I'm feeling gay after that conversation.
Do you think there's a straw?
My dog isn't gay. Yeah.
Do you think there's a straw that broke the like his back finally? You think there was? I believe there was one phone call that really said, "That's it."
No, I told you there wasn't one.
So that maybe it's when you slowly decided, like along the you know.
No, I told you. The thing with my son was probably what pushed it over the edge.
Yeah. He's worried about his boy.
Yeah. I mean, you know.
But it was still his wife who said, you know what, we can't do this to our son.
Had you started practicing?
Oh, my God.
Had you started taking some things?
No.
Come on, Scott.
That would have really sucked.
No. Scott.
What were you up to?
Come on.
A bowling pin.
Half a finger.
Pencil.
Hey, Howard, it would have been great, man. You could have played the theme from Deliverance while it was going on.
Yeah, God only knows what we would have played. Multiple songs. All right, bro.
Take it easy, man.
All right.
That sucks.
Artie, how looking forward to it with you? Well, look, I mean, obviously it would have been very entertaining.
Would have been awesome. I never got such...
Yeah, I mean, we had it all laid out. It was ready to unfold.
I never got such positive email about any one bit. Like, maybe one or two letters of protest saying it was too gay. Everyone else was like, this is going to be the greatest ever.
I couldn't wait to see it.
Yeah.
$250,000.
Yeah.
Because it's still the one thing that remains to be seen is if he could actually do it.
$250,000.
Ka-ching.
Yeah. You know what? Tell your son to put up with some crap at school.
No.
$250,000.
No. Yeah,
school only lasts a couple of years.
No.
I think this is Scott backing out.
Yeah.
Because he saw the picture of Lexington Steel and he freaked.
Maybe I'm not gay. You know? Figure that one out.
Well, maybe you are.
No.
We certainly have a price.
Obviously not.
If you didn't have a son, you're saying you would do it. So you're gay.
Yeah, if I was single and gay, I would do it.
No, if you were single, you would do it.
Get away from me. Get away from me.
What is that?
Oh, nice. Cross-dressing.
Here. Ronnie's really pissed because in the hallway, he's like, I want to go in and say, Scott's got to pay. Scott's got to pay for this. He's got to pay us for, like, you know, screw.
Oh, come on.
That's what he was saying.
He's right. I should have said to you right from the beginning so I didn't waste my time with my pay-per-view connections. I should have said to you right from the beginning, Scott, if you're not into this, you owe me money.
Well, that's why I'm telling you now not to go any further. So you don't set everything up later. So you don't set everything up and then
All right. We're done with you.
We already asked you if you were going to back out if we set everything up and you lied.
Scott's usual integrity came through. Yeah. No way am I backing out.
You can go ahead.
It's a go.
It's a go. To quote you.
I'm the master of my own ass.
All right. We're going to take a break. We'll be back right after these words.